almost all of the drivers here. What is the biggest concern? Is it the 90-degree heat today? Is it the concrete? Is it the fact that the track narrows by 10 feet off the corner? What?
Well, all of that and a whole bunch more as well. We have a 43-foot wide pit road. It's really easy to get in trouble there. Look, having a good day at Dover is a little bit like going through three speed traps on the way to the IRS. Get through all three speed traps without a ticket, and then have the IRS decide they owe you thousands. It's a big day when you have a good day at Dover.
One guy who had a great day here on Friday was Bobby Labonte, the pole sitter here for the Budweiser pole. He came out and just blistered this racetrack. When you think about the fact that 32 drivers broke the old track record, and then three more, as we said earlier, did so in second round butt pole qualifying, well, you get the idea. This place is quick, Dick.
It's incredibly fast, but Bobby Labonte and team are worried about this car. It is extremely fast on fresh tires, but it is not as quick once the tires break in, so they've thrown a whole armload of things at it to try to give them speed in the race.
And that's something we've seen from a lot of folks, Steve Burns. Folks trying all sorts of different combinations here this weekend.
And Eli with Bobby Labonte. Now, Bobby, I've heard you say it all weekend. It's great to start first, but you want to finish first. Tell us about your race car.
Well, yesterday afternoon, we were a little bit, not quite what we wanted to be, but we worked on it a little bit after that. And this morning, I think we got a little bit better. But first, it's a great place to start. If we can't finish there, we got to do the best we can. But we're awfully excited about today, that's for sure.
Bobby, a lot of guys talk about this concrete surface. Your thoughts on it?
It's concrete. It's hard. I don't know, I thought about a bicycle track would be good. Yeah, they got those concrete bicycle tracks, a little smaller, but this would be like a speedway version for them guys. So it's tough to get your car set up for. Every time it's a little different. So hopefully we got enough adjustability. If the track does change, we can adjust our car.
That's the pole sitter, Bobby Labonte. Ralph Shaheen?
Well, Kenny Wallace has got qualifying figured out. A second at Richmond, a third at Charlotte, and a fourth here at Dover. But now we got to get you in victory lane. What's lacking there?
Well, I don't really know yet. It's I think what's lacking is that, you know, this is probably my 11th or 12th race with this team. You know, right now all this qualifying just goes, a lot of the credit goes to, Lloyd at TNL, all them guys out under Concord, North Carolina. They've given me just unbelievable motors since Richmond. And then Jerry Vest at APR is building the race motors. So they've all come together and been able to focus in on their job, and it's making me look a little better. So, once I learn, like Bobby Labonte calls it, that top 10 thing, I think then I can put myself in position and get a little more experience to win a race. So we're working at it.
You said you used to hate this place, but then you changed your mind and decided you were going to conquer it. So what was the change?
Well, you know, when somebody tells you you have to do something and you don't want to do it, like take out the garbage or clean something, but you know you got to do it, that's what changed my mind, that philosophy. Every time I came to Dover, I never had good luck. It's not that I hated the racetrack. Just every time I come here, something happens. Finally, I just got ready to get on the airplane about 3 years ago, and I said, you know what? I love Dover. God, it's great. And, it's a tough racetrack, but it's paid off. We ran good in the Busch car yesterday, and so far, so good here.
He liked it in qualifying, Eli. He'll start fourth.
We'll follow him throughout the day. And does winning the Bud Pole automatically mean free entree into victory lane? Well, as you see, clearly not only 9 of 58 winners here have ever come from the best starting position. Only three times has that happened in the spring race here at Dover. When we come back, how about a look back at last year's surprising victory and how things changed with just 7 miles to go. That's next.
Things that make you go. Break it down.
The crispy, juicy chicken sandwich at Burger King. At just 99 cents, the taste isn't the only thing that makes you go.
When you have it your way, it just tastes better.
Need brakes? Now during the Midas $40 lifetime brakes rebate, save $20 per axle or $40 for your whole car. Lifetime guarantee $40 in savings right now. Go safely. Go Midas.
Call it a bonanza, an extravaganza. It's how you save on tires. Now at Pep Boys, all 35,000-mile tires are 4 for only $99, and all 70,000-mile tires, 4 for $169.
Pep Boys, cars like us,
people love us.
Last year in this race, Rusty Wallace was on the pole, but it quickly became the Jeff Gordon show. He avoided this wreck and then went on to lead 375 of the 400 laps, but Gordon had to stop for fuel with 7 laps to go, allowing Dale Jarrett to pick up a somewhat unexpected victory. And again, that's why folks come to the racetrack. You just never know. Hey, if you're looking for the ride of your life, log on now to today's TNNRacing.com. It's a live webcast of the MBNA Platinum 400. You'll be able to ride along with your choice of in-car cameras. There'll be the fan scan, scanner talk, and all the internet's hottest interactive multimedia racing features. It's available now at TNNRacing.com.
Did you get them brakes at Pep Boys?
Yeah, I did.
I appreciate it.
Pep Boys means quality parts and brake service from just $79.99.
Pep Boys.
Cars like us.
People love us.
Out of luck with a flat tire? Not with this tire. Even with no air pressure, you drive to safety. Goodyear Aqua Steel Run Flat. Find the safe way home.
Goodyear.
Every time I call, you're on the phone. Who are you talking to?
Friends, family, people I don't see that much.
Phone bills must be killing you.
No, I dial 1010321. Saves 50% on calls over 10 minutes.
50%? Wow. Am I ever going to get the shoot?
Not playing against me.
Final few moments of pre-race activities taking place on the main straightaway as we close in on the start of the MBNA Platinum 400 here at Dover Downs International Speedway in Delaware. All right, we've talked about the stories. We've talked about the personalities. We've not forgotten you gearheads out there. We talk all about the concrete racetrack. What does that really mean as far as a crew chief trying to set up a race car is concerned? Well, earlier, Glenn Jarrett spent time with Larry McReynolds, crew chief for Mike Skinner.
Hey, thanks, Eli. You know, the Monster Mile here at Dover has always been a crew chief's nightmare. But since 1995, when they concreted this place, the problems were compounded. Now, Larry McReynolds, the crew chief for Mike Skinner's car, is here. We're going to talk about some of the things that you have to do to set up a car to go around this racetrack, Larry. We came back this time. It's faster than ever. What do you have to do to make a car go around here fast?
Well, there's such a compromise here, Glenn. You know, you've got to make the car where they can drive it down in the corner and not be loose. And the big key is cutting the center of the corner, making that car stay at the bottom. If you ever drift up, it's almost like Daytona and Talladega. A bunch of cars is going to freight train you. Where you pass people is from the center off. You don't beat them getting down in the corner, and that's something I've been working with Mike on ever since we've been talking about this place. But the big concern is the speeds. Are we going to be okay with the tire here? The tire never gets a rest here. It's gripping, biting all the way around this mile concrete racetrack, and that's one concern. Big thing is keep those tires on it, be able to run 100 laps, which is a fuel stop on those tires, and be at the end of this race.
And that's the key, to be around at the end of this race.
We're closing on the start at Dover Downs Speedway. We'll be right back with more.
TNN, America's country home, is a service of CBS Cable.
It's more than country music's biggest night. It's fantastic.
Your votes make it happen.
The TNN Music City News Country Awards.
Everybody's going to be there.
Hosted by Jeff Foxworthy.
And I'm not nominated.
It's a night of nonstop fun that you won't want to miss.
With performances by Alan, Faith, Vince, Anita, Sawyer Brown, and more.
What a lineup.
And what a night.
The TNN Music City News Country Awards, live June 14th, 8 Eastern, only on TNN.
Nothing beats the excitement of NASCAR. And now, when you watch NASCAR on TNN, you can win a free trip to a NASCAR Winston Cup race and a chance to win a Ford truck. Hi again, everybody. I'm Eli Gold. Be sure to enter the TNN Pedal to the Metal NASCAR Sweepstakes. Here's how it works. Watch the MBNA Platinum 400 on TNN Sunday, June 6th, live from Dover Downs. On a postcard, write down who's leading at the halfway point. Send it in with your name, address, and phone number to TNN. Pedal to the metal NASCAR sweepstakes. TNN Station, P.O. Box 3582, Southbury, Connecticut 06488. Or enter online at country.com. If you win, you're going on an all-expense-paid VIP trip to see the Pocono 500 in Pennsylvania. You'll also be eligible to win the grand prize at F-150 Ford truck. Don't forget, watch the MBNA Platinum 400 on TNN, and maybe you'll put the pedal to the metal in a 99 Ford truck brought to you by Ford and the Mississippi Board of Tourism. The following is a special presentation of TNN Motorsports. As the triumphs and trials of May fade into early June, the thrill of the pageantry, the heat of the spotlight, the thousands of weary miles traveled, the long hours of intensity melt into a small corner of Delaware and business as usual.
When I feel like I can't get over the solid white cliffs of Dover, when I don't know what to do, baby, see me through. Well, I've been too long in the storm. I feel so sad and forlorn. And perhaps I'm counting on you. See me through.
Power, the tenacity, and a little luck, Dover's rewards await.
'99 started off on a roll for Jeff Gordon. He won the Daytona 500. He's won three races altogether, but tide has turned for Jeff Gordon. Four times this season, he's failed to finish a race in the number 24 car. Only twice last year, he failed to finish the entire season. He's taken a tumble in the point standings. He comes to Dover in the eighth position in points. And today, Jeff Gordon starts 14th. This race is just seconds from starting, but he has three wins on this racetrack.
Jarrett has only one victory in 1999, but consistency has been the key for him leading the points this year. Take, for example, the Richmond race, where he started 21st, but the crew worked hard all night long as the Yates crew brought him to victory lane. Today, he'll utilize Yates chassis number 26. It's the winningest car in the Yates stable. However, it only has been raced twice since 1997. Dale Jarrett will start second today.
Jeff Burton's star has risen to the top in 1999. He already has three victories, including last week's at Charlotte, where coupled with a Winston Noble million bonus, his earnings for the season so far are over $2.4 million. He has eight top fives, nine top tens, and he currently sits second to Dale Jarrett in the point standings. But Dover has been a problem, particularly qualifying. He has had to use a provisional spot. Once again, he will start 37th, way back in the field. They feel like they have the car to get to the front, but only if the monster doesn't bite them on the way through. All these stories and more are coming your way next, live right here on TNN.
Began a arriving early. They have come in record numbers. 122,000 fans ringing the 1 mile Dover Downs International Speedway in Delaware. The MBNA Platinum 400 moments away right here on TNN Motorsports. Welcome back to Dover, Delaware, everybody. I'm Eli Gold. Friday afternoon, we got a quick indication of how quick this weekend would be. Bobby Labonte went out qualifying and blistered the old track record. A total of 35 drivers set a new track record, but not Ernie Irvin yesterday. Final practice happy hour was anything but happy for him. And as a matter of fact, Ernie Irvin has now failed to finish 7 of 12 races this year, and he has lost 9 cars in the process. Buddy Baker is alongside, and as Melvin Joseph gives the command to fire the engines trackside, let's talk about Bobby Labonte. As hot as he is, winning 2 poles plus a third at the Winston in succession, could he be the guy?
I think he is. He's this close to moving up, being a superstar. He's already a star, but he has the car, he has the team, and the crew that can get him out there. Bobby Labonte is on the brink of being a superstar.
But how about these high speeds, Dick Berggren? When we see that, oftentimes it's accompanied by tire problems. Any concern in the garage?
Yeah, there definitely is. This place was already the toughest racetrack on the circuit on right front tires. Increased speed simply means increased pressure on those tires. Now, Goodyear has got a special tire here that they use for Dover and Dover only. They have tested it. It seems just fine. But there's extra pressure on the drivers as well. Increased speed means less time to make a mistake and get away with it.
They did have a 90-minute final practice here yesterday instead of the normal 60 minutes. They all have scuffed in extra sets of tires. Wayne Torrance, the Goodyear engineer, says no problem. We're set to go racing, and we're tickled to have you with us. We're live together on TNN Motorsports.
Rock and roll!
Keep your car rocking. Protect your engine with Havoline Formula 3 motor oil. Add more life to your car.
Move it. They're catching us.
In our quest for the finest brakes in the world, we tested our pads against other leading brands. With pad after pad, in test after test, the results were always the same. No other brand stopped shorter than Performance Friction Carbon Metallic. The ones we stock at AutoZone.
For Dan and Lisa, it just clicked. So they loaded up their Ford Expedition and got back to doing what they loved. Answering the call of the wild.
I lost them.
And they unleashed a beast of their own. That big 5.4-liter Triton V8. And you thought Little Red Riding Hood got a close look. Ford Expedition, built Ford tough.
Hi, I'm Jeff Burton with an exciting message for NASCAR fans. Buy any Exide NASCAR Select product and get a Motorola pager free. It's a great way to enter the Exide NASCAR Select 99 sweepstakes. Every month you'll be paged with another chance to win cool prizes. You could even win $50,000 and be an honorary member of the Exide Racing Team pit crew for the first race of the next century. Look for details wherever Exide NASCAR Select is sold.
Holy cow, man, I gotta find a phone. TNN Motorsports live coverage of the MBNA Platinum 400 is being brought to you by Havoline Formula 3 Motor Oil. Add more life to your car. Find the more than 2,500 AutoZone stores across America. AutoZone, the best parts in auto parts. By Ford, the official truck of NASCAR, is built Ford tough. And by Exide, NASCAR Select, the official automotive battery of NASCAR. Welcome back as the field now begins to rumble here at the Monster Mile. Let's check out the AutoZone prep for the race, brought to you by the more than 2,500 AutoZone stores across America. AutoZone, the best parts in auto parts. And indeed, look at that, 9 different winners in the last 9 spring races here at the Monster Mile. If you're not familiar with this racetrack, why don't we give you a bit of a graphic look at it, so you'll know exactly what we talk about when we discuss the Dover Downs International Speedway, the Ford track description, brought to you by the maker of vehicles that are built to last, Ford. 24 degrees in the turns, 9 degrees of banking on the straightaway, and it is a true one-mile layout here in Dover, Delaware. All right, who's here and who's not? The starting grid looks like this. Bobby Labonte, fourth pole of the year. Dale Jarrett, the 98 race winner here. Mark Martin with a couple of victories at Dover. And Kenny Wallace, he has gotten hot all of a sudden, guys. If qualifying can translate to race performance, Kenny might be a guy to watch along with Kyle Petty.
He said this morning this is his best chance for a great finish in his whole career.
There you see Mike Skinner and Jeremy Mayfield sharing row number five. Elliott Sadler, first Dover Winston Cup start here. Jeff Gordon with three wins at this racetrack. Wally Dallenbach has had mixed success. Brett Bodine looking for a good run here today. You know who else, buddy? The guy starting in row 12 right there, Ricky Rudd, has four Dover wins.
Yes, he does. And I think Ricky Rudd has the temperament for this racetrack. He tries to keep the fender straight on that race car and stay out of problems.
Steve Park, Jeffrey Bodine, used to be the ultimate track record holder here when he drove a modified around the Monster Mile. And now the fellas who are in on provisional starting spots, Robert Presley, Ricky Craven, and from Wausau, Wisconsin, Dave Marcus going shotgun on the field. Those who didn't qualify include Darrell Waltrip, Hut Strickland, and Buckshot Jones, those three drivers failing to make the field. Robert Presley. There you see Robert. You just saw Jeff Burton moments ago. They'll be giving us rides around the racetrack. Tony Stewart in the Home Depot car. Kenny Irwin had a pretty decent run here yesterday in the NASCAR Busch Series race.
He certainly did. He was right up front all the way through. And you see the head restraints right there on all the helmets. These guys need those today. You have so much push on in the corners here. I don't know how many G's you pull, but Mark Martin will wear that thing out today with that helmet.
And there you see the pole sitter, Bobby Labonte, set to give us a ride. Pace car ducking down the pit lane. And we are set to go racing here at Dover. Glad you're with us on TNN. Are the areas that have been ground down to make this track even smoother. Bobby Labonte leading, Mark Martin in second. Bobby has led all 10 of this year's Super Speedway races. Matter of fact, the only race he hasn't led this year was at Bristol.
And remarkably, they've got the Bristol car here.
And here comes Mark Martin making a move on the inside on Bobby Labonte. Mark Martin's car is getting great grip right on the bottom of the racetrack. You can see Labonte's car sweep up the racetrack, not getting the handle on the in the corners like the car of Martin.
Riding with Mark Martin, looking rearward towards the Interstate Batteries car.
Look at all the people surrounding this speedway, 122,000 strong. They're still going to build some more grandstands here in the first and second turn. Everybody seems to want to come to Dover and watch the races.
Well, yeah. There's not a bad seat because it's only a one-mile racetrack.
And, too, degrees of banking here. 9 degrees down the straightaway even. You can see everything that's going on. You can see how high the bleachers are there, and that gives you a good idea of the crowd. That's just a grandstand. There must be 35, 40,000 people on the infield.
You see the field now sorting itself out on the start. One guy we've not talked much about today is Kevin LePage, who has settled in fourth spot right now behind Mark Martin, Bobby Labonte, and Dale Jarrett. He's going to be a factor certainly this afternoon.
You see Jeff Burton in the 99 there, back in the back of the pack here. Earnhardt.
Trouble. Main straightaway. Kenny Schrader, whose last win was here in June of 1991. You see all the fluid he has deposited on the racetrack. And caution is out. A heartbreaker again for the Skoll team. Kenny Schrader in the wall in turn one. And he's done himself some damage.
Eli, he busted the radiator when he hit the wall on the outside there, spinning up into the wall.
Dick Trickle also involved in it. There's Trickle in the number 91 car, the Larry's Holmes car. Joe Falk owns that one. Boy, it has been up as well.
Let's take a look at exactly what happened going into one. You see two separate incidents there. Clearly, you saw Schrader ahead of Trickle by, looked like, what, 10, 12 cars, if not more. So two separate incidents.
Eli, I was watching. There was a car that really got backwards about halfway down the straightaway there, and I think they saw the wreck. Maybe Trickle backed off a little bit and got rear-ended and turned him into the inside wall.
Now, there goes Kenny Schrader, the pride of Fenton, Missouri. Spends all weekend, runs for 1 minute and 35 seconds, and apparently his day is done.
What can I do you for, young fella? Just a filter. Just a filter. Did anyone else hear that? Son, you put inferior oil filters in your engine, and it's not long for this world. Look, nothing's more dependable than America's number one filter, Fram. You'll thank me someday. Youth.
Fram oil filters. Pay a little more now or pay a lot later. And now Fram's rough-textured Sure Grip top makes changing your filter easier.
To help you remember 10, 10, 3, 4, 5 long distance, we're here with grades 3, 4, and 5 of Center Grove School. With 10, 10, 3, 4, 5, calls are always 10 cents a minute, anytime, any day. No minimum talk time and no monthly fee. So, what's that number?
10, 10, 3, 4, 5.
Excellent. You're promoted. 10, 10, 3, 4, 5. The simple way to save on long distance.
Dial 10, 10, 3, 4, 5 today.
This is a sport that brings families together. Most of the time, anyway.
You're mine today, buddy. That rooster's crowing a little early this morning, isn't it?
This is a sport where the hearts race every bit as fast as the cars. And this is a sport where some of its biggest fans are some of its smallest.
See your local dealer for big savings on select models.
Call it a bonanza, an extravaganza. It's how you save on tires. Now at Pep Boys, all 35,000-mile tires are four for only $99, and all 70,000-mile tires, four for $169.
Pep Boys, cars like us,
people love us.
We've heard your complaints about changing your oil filter, trying to grip that slippery filter. That's why Fram, America's number one filter, now has Sure Grip, a rough textured top for easy gripping and installing.
It makes changing your oil filter a lot easier.
How quickly is Tony Stewart getting around this racetrack? Well, now he has lapped all the way up to the 15th place runner. Let's set it for you so you'll know exactly where everybody is. Wally Donham back in the 25. He is a lap down now in 15th. Steve Park, the number one car, he is in 16th. So he and Wally are battling for position. Sterling Marlin has made a number of unscheduled pit stops here of late. And Sterling is right now in 38th position, four laps down. The 18 is Bobby Labonte. He is second, and he's being shown at this stage some 4 seconds behind the race leader. Then you come further back to Mark Martin, who has led much of the day. Mark is being shown at this point in third position. then you've got the Ward Burton car. Ward is in a lap down, running in 17th position. That's the Cat car. Then you come back to Rusty Wallace. We just talked about Rusty, and there he is, running in the fourth spot right now, one of the 15 cars on the lead lap. Kevin LePage, he has been running awfully well, and there is Kevin LePage right now. He has fallen off the lead lap, though. He is an 18th, one lap behind the leader. Kyle Petty had to make a couple of unscheduled pit stops. He's now four laps down in that car number 44. He's running in 35th position. Then further back, you've got Dale Earnhardt, who went a lap down after just only 60 laps. He is in 19th. And there's Derek Culp, who is now finding himself three laps down in 36th position. Derek is in car number 30. Then we take you further back to the Kenny Wallace car. He is in fifth. Kenny is in fifth spot, but he is finding himself now back about 10 seconds from the race leader, but obviously on the lead lap. Then you've got Andretti in the 43. John is 19th position on the racetrack, a lap down. Jeff Gordon, he is 10 and a half seconds back of the leader. The 24 is running sixth. Jeffrey Bodine is a lap down in 21st in car number 60. The 45 is Rich Bickle, doing far better today than he did in qualifying. He's running in 33rd, three laps down. You've got the 11 of Brett Bodine. He's also three laps down, now being shown in 32nd position. The 88 is Dale Jarrett. He is in seventh spot, 11 and 4/10 seconds behind the race leader, Tony Stewart. We've already talked about Rich Bickle there, so we'll wait for Ricky Rudd to come into the screen. And Ricky in the number 10 Tide ride, he's right now in 22nd spot, one lap down to the race leader. Further back, Johnny Benson, car number 26. Johnny is in 23rd spot. He's running with Ricky Rudd, battling for position. Then you see the 31 of Mike Skinner. Skinner is 11 and 6/10 seconds back behind the leader, but he's on the lead lap in 8th place. Ernie Irvin in his backup car after the accident yesterday. Ernie's now 7 laps down in 39th position. Didn't get much time to work out the kinks in that backup after he lost the primary car in happy hour practice yesterday. Then we go back further to Jerry Nadeau in the 9, Ricky Craven in the 58, and Bobby Hamilton in the 4. Jerry Nadeau is in 24th spot. Hamilton is in 25th. Each one is a lap down, while Craven is 34th. He is two laps down to the race leader, Tony Stewart. Dave Marcus back out of the garage, 32 laps down. He is running in 40th position. Remember, Dave had that oil leak that sent him to the garage. David Green is in car number 41, and he is running in 26th, two laps down to Tony Stewart, the race leader. We've not seen Jeremy Mayfield in this flashback for you. He's on the lead lap. Jeremy is now 16 seconds back in 9th position, but trying to keep pace, as everybody is, with Tony Stewart. Jeff Burton now is running in 10th. He is 17 seconds back of the race leader, but one of 15 guys still on the lead lap. Chad Little will be next in our picture, the John Deere entry. He is right now being shown two laps down in 27th position. Kenny Irwin's on the lead lap, the 28th car. He is in 11th. He's 21 and 3/10 seconds back, so he's darn close to being a lap down to Tony Stewart. Ted Musgrave is right there in car number 75. He is two laps down in 28th. Seemingly everybody is laps down, as well as we're getting the leaders around today. Rick Mast in that number 98 machine is on the speedway. He is on the lead lap. Rick Mast and Bill Elliott both, the 98 and the 94, are running 12th and 13th on the speedway. And then you'll circle right back around to Tony Stewart, who is about to put the 12th and 13th place runners down a lap. So there you see exactly who's still running. The guys officially out of the race are Dick Trickle and Michael Waltrip. Kenny Schrader's team still trying to rebuild his car after the accident that brought out the first caution at lap number 6. So Tony Stewart is the race leader, putting Bill Elliott a lap down if he can. But a lot of folks say, yeah, the Valvoline guy has not yet been heard from.
Just because you're in front doesn't mean you sit back and watch the others try and catch up. If you can make a great thing better, you do it. And that's what they've done with new Mobil 1 Tri-Synthetic. That's a bit of a mouthful, but basically it means new Mobil 1 protects against engine wear better than ever before. Helps your anti-pollution gear work better too. For me, using anything less just isn't an option.
Nothing outperforms Mobil 1.
I want to like Rebecca, I really do. But she thinks Miller Lite tastes great because it's smooth.
And Rick thinks it's because of the choice hops.
And even if we could get past that, we'd still argue over whose work sells the most sports magazines.
Okay, in-depth analysis of the nickel defense or fishnet bikinis. You decide.
Look, Rebecca, guys buy sports magazines for great sports writing.
Oh, great. So I guess we'll be seeing that Rick Riley sports writing calendar any day now.
Oh, man.
Miller Lite, the great taste of a...
Admit, it is kind of sexy.
When you have it your way, it just tastes better.
To help you remember 10, 10, 3, 4, 5 long distance, we're looking at the third, fourth, and fifth planets. You can call anywhere in the world and save up to 50%. Calls to Italy, Germany, and France are only 20 cents a minute.
Well, I've just been informed that Jupiter, not Saturn, is the fifth planet.
10, 10, 3, 4, 5. The simple way to save on all your long distance.
Well, we made a couple changes on the chassis this morning. Last night, in the final practice, the car was just a little bit too tight. So we changed the record.
Sorry.
Anyway, by changing that right rear spring, and by adjusting that air pressure a little bit, I think it's going to help the car turn a little bit better off the corner, therefore run a little... run a little bit faster lap times.
Tony Stewart still enjoying the day. Hope you are as well. And don't forget, folks, country.com is where TNN hangs out on the World Wide Web. It is your personal source for all things country, from race cars to country stars. Connect to country.com. And remember, too, NASCAR's home on the World Wide Web is at NASCAR.com. NASCAR Online, before, during, and today, even after the race. It's your 24-hour NASCAR garage pass, and as we head back up the highway towards the Philadelphia airport, we're going to be doing a chat session on NASCAR.com this afternoon, so you folks can submit your questions, and we'll come up with an answer. If we don't know it, we'll make one up, whatever.
Well, this with the race traffic, we know you'll not be chatting at high speed.
That's for darn sure, but we certainly hope you can make your plans to check out NASCAR Online anytime. Well, Tony Stewart just getting around Dave Marcus's car, smoking fairly heavily on the racetrack again, but there he is getting off the racing surface, and he'll head back to the garage area. But Ralph, not Dave Marcus, not anybody seemingly bothering Tony Stewart.
No, Eli, and one other thing that's not really affecting Tony Stewart at this point in time is the weather conditions. This is the first race in the heat of summer, and it's probably the warmest it's been on pit road so far in the 1999 racing season. So you can only imagine what the temperatures are like inside the cockpit. To combat the heat this year, the Joe Gibbs Racing team has built a special sauna for Tony and for Bobby Labonte to use. The driver sit on a bicycle inside a sauna with a video screen rigged up and a video game of a racetrack that they can play whichever race they're going to. They get in the sauna, they drive the entire race distance in the heat of the sauna to try to get themselves acclimated and tight the temperatures they'll be exerted upon themselves when they get to the racetrack.
You know, we've told the story before. You know, he used to do a similar deal, not with that modern technology, with Bobby Allison. He used to ride around at home in Hueytown, Alabama, with the windows rolled up and the heat full blast in his passenger car. He wouldn't use air conditioning in the house on Church Street in Hueytown. He said, I have to be acclimated in time for race day.
Yeah, but it was hard to get rid of that car at the end of the year, believe me.
Tony Stewart putting Kenny Irwin down a lap. Yesterday,
when 11.
Yeah, yesterday when happy hour ended, the mechanics were all working on the cars. They were all dealing with suspensions and shock absorbers and carburetors and engines. Tony Stewart was working on his car as well with a very large hammer beating on the seat of the car. I guess he was adjusting a piece of fine furniture for greater comfort. He was just in there, bam, bam, on the seat. I guess it worked out well.
That's the only thing that we used to have to do as a driver. Once I got up into the better cars, they wouldn't let me work on them anymore like they did when I first started out. I worked on my own cars. But they said, the seat is your property. If you're uncomfortable, it's your fault. You put it in there, you adjust it, you make it comfortable. We don't want to hear about you not being comfortable in the race car.
Caution numbers, if you're just joining us, only one came out on lap number six. Separate incidents at the same time. Kenny Schrader at one end of the track and Dick Trickle at the other. And otherwise, we've been clean and green. Of course, saying that is like putting this race on the cover of Sports Illustrated. You know, they're going to start flying the cautions. It always happens when you talk about them.
Nine of them yesterday in the Busch Series race.
Yeah, one
lot
shy of the record there.
Yeah.
But that came in boxes too. Why is that, buddy? You've driven these cars so long. You go caution free for so long. Is it because everybody got bunched up again on that one restart that you'd have a bunch of quick cautions after that?
Okay, well, you're out there running. No cautions, and the cars are not handling well, so you back off the cars. Then you make adjustments. You say, okay, it's perfect. Now you fall down in the corner there as hard as it'll go. Somebody gets under you, make a little contact, it just sets everybody flat.
I believe. There's the MBNA machine, Bobby Labonte. He is 3 2/10 seconds behind Tony Stewart. Notice the MBNA is on the hood this week. You can kind of see it there as normally an associate on the car, but the Interstate Batteries and MBNA swapped hood positions today because this is a race sponsored by MBNA.
See Bobby Labonte there, just behind him. Mark Martin's just riding along. We got a report just a few seconds.
Caution on the speedway.
What in the world?
We've got caution on the speedway. We've got oil again. Dave Marcus's car has slowed once more and has gone to the pit road this time. But there you see Dave going right to the garage. But oil on the speedway. And we are under caution. I told you.
Hey, lad, there's one thing about it. Down in going on the flat part of the racetrack out of the pits, there's a huge ring of oil that goes all the way around to the back straightaway. You can see it as they come around, and they don't want somebody to make a pit stop under green and go out and maybe hit that oil and slide into somebody.
And there you see some more of it in pit road, Ralph. And like Buddy said, you know, it could be as disastrous on the pit lane as on the racetrack.
Eli, that's going to be the biggest problem for Tony Stewart right now because Dave Marcus was pitted just behind Tony. So when he rolled through pit road, it rolled all the oil right through Tony Stewart's pit box. They have gone out and put grease sweep out there, and they're trying to sweep it off. But Tony Stewart's pit stall right now is a bit of a mess while the crew communicates over the radio as to what it is they want to do to this car.
Well, NASCAR has just told all the crew chiefs. They said, fellas, there's no need for us to take any chances on these pit stops. Pit road is still closed. Everybody's out there with their push brooms and the speedy dry, except for the audio guys. They don't use push brooms and speedy dry.
Out of luck with a flat tire? Not with this tire. Even with no air pressure, you drive to safety. Goodyear Aqua Steel Run Flat. Find the safe way home.
From the place you've trusted forever, the brand you can trust just as long, the Bring Ace Home Sale. Ace is a place with the helpful hardware folks.
There's a lot of reasons why so many people who take care of their cars turn to AutoZone each week. The low prices on the replacement parts they really need, and the large selection of the things they simply want. But most of all, they come to AutoZone because of the helpful, friendly people who work there. The kind of folks who know their stuff and who'll go the extra mile to help you out. Because after all, taking pride in taking care of people is what AutoZone is all about.
Some things are obvious from the start. Like, things turn out better when you work together. That's why the UAW International Union and General Motors Corporation got together to create programs to improve skills and safety, to educate, to promote teamwork and build better quality cars and trucks. Assembly line to finish line. Teamwork wins.
Liblog Day 19. Traveling the circuits of NASCAR.
Darlington, Daytona, Talladega, Charlotte. The drivers, the cars, the action. Bumper to bumper, mano-a-mano at speeds of over 200 miles an hour, with us covering every heart-pounding, adrenaline-pumping moment at the incredible speed of over
35 miles an hour, as fast as it goes.
What?
It's a good thing they keep going around in circles.
TNN Motorsports live coverage of the MBNA Platinum 400 is being brought to you by the more than 2,500 AutoZone stores across America. AutoZone, the best parts in auto parts. By UAWGM, assembly line to finish line, teamwork wins. And by Brewery Fresh Budweiser, official beer of NASCAR. This Bud's for you. They see the flag waving, signifying that pit road remains closed. They have put down with the truck speedy drive from one end of the pit lane to the other, and on the low groove of the racetrack where Dave Marcus did his best to get out of everybody's way, but wasn't his fault that it was just venting oil all the way around the racetrack. So the cleanup will continue a while, and then pit stops will begin here at Dover Downs, Delaware.
We've heard your complaints about changing your oil filter, banging your knuckles trying to grip that slippery filter. That's why Fram, America's number one filter, now has Sure Grip, a rough textured top on our Extra Guard filter for easy gripping and installing. Only Fram has it.
It makes changing your oil filter a lot easier.
Fram oil filters. Pay a little more now, or pay a lot later.
Need brakes? Now during the Midas $40 Lifetime Brakes Rebate, save $20 per axle or $40 for your whole car. Lifetime guarantee $40 in savings right now. Go safely. Go Midas.
This summer, if you can dream it up, Sonic can put it in a cup. We've got hundreds of drink flavors you can mix and match. Plus, our 44-ounce Route 44 Big Drinks. Enough choices to let your dreams run wild.
Sonic America's driving.
Join CBS as NASCAR hits the road with concerts featuring today's hottest performers. Feel the rush of NASCAR Rock.
The Pocono 500, June 20th at 1 Eastern on TNN.
The Outlaws are back in town Wednesday night, June 16th at Tri-City Speedway. You want to be there for the greatest chill on earth? Tickets are on sale now. All kids are just $10. Order your reserve seat now at 314-469-9666. Use MasterCard or Visa.
The World of Outlaws.
$50,000 Big Bud Shootout. Wednesday night, June 16th at Tri-City Speedway. You want to be there. Don't miss it.
There's a place deep in the heartland where 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, people who thought they'd never get a car are getting a car loan right over the phone. It's Auto Hotline USA, one of the country's best sources for auto loans. Bankruptcy, recent divorce, bad credit, even no credit, all are no problem with Auto Hotline USA. Call 1-888-741-AUTO. That's 888-741-2886, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Get an auto loan on your Touchstone phone.
Welcome back to the Monster Mile. After Bobby Labonte started from the pole, lap number 4, Mark Martin took the lead from him. But Bobby Labonte says, I'll see your lead and take it right back. And he did so at lap number 94. But then the rookie came to call. Tony Stewart in the Home Depot machine grabs the lead at lap 95 and holds it to this moment, lap 167. Here at Dover Downs International Speedway. That is the outside behind the main grandstand of Dover Downs International. Out of the fans enjoying the trips to the concession stands. We're still under caution. They're blowing the excess speedy dry, Glenn, off the racetrack now. So it'll be a few moments yet.
Yeah, guys, look at the shot. If we can get a shot overhead of Rusty Wallace way down on the bottom. For the last two laps under caution, he's been telling his guys he thinks he's out of fuel. Now, I don't see how that's possible. He's only been about 70, 75 laps on this fuel run. The only way possible is if they just didn't get it full of fuel. But he is having a heck of a time. He's even talking to him about trying to get Jeremy Mayfield to push the car should he completely run out of gas. Big problem for Rusty.
Now, Rusty pitted at lap number 92. That's about 73, 74 miles, unless he didn't get it full.
Eli, when you're running slow, though, the pickup in the back of the tank there is right on the right-hand corner, and they're running around there very slow, and most of the fuel is over on the left-hand side of the fuel cell. He may be experiencing a little bit of a fuel problem there in the bank. You see him on the flat down here in the corner.
And despite the fact that pit road is closed, we have seen Ernie Irvin pit. We've seen Brett Bodine pit. We've seen Bobby Hamilton pit. Maybe they're all experiencing the same problem.
Well, let's remember this race last year as well. Rusty Wallace did have problems with fuel at the very beginning of the race. He got just absolutely horrid mileage, much worse than anybody else, went down two laps. There he is riding along the flat of the racetrack, trying to get as much fuel as he can to the pickup in that fuel cell. Boy, two races in a row with fuel problems here at Dover.
Well, pit stops will be forthcoming eventually, but right now the cleanup of the oil on the racetrack is the number one priority.
It's about a vision for moving earth, goods, even children, better, more safely. Backed by people driven to exceed your expectations. Come ride with a leader that's taking a new road. International. Delivering beyond the expected.
Hey, Ray! Those brake pads really did the trick.
Great.
I got a couple more things I need. Do you think you have these?
Thanks. No problem. Hey, Jeff, can you get these for Dan?
I'm on it.
Hey, Dan, here you go. Anything else?
No, I think this'll do it.
All right, great.
Thanks, guys.
Not as fast as Charlotte.
Yeah, I know. It's a little slow in that turn at aisle three.
Advance Auto Parts. The best part is our people.
Good morning, Mr. Clark.
Morning, Tommy.
Good morning, Mr. Clark.
Morning, Tommy.
Good morning, Mr. Clark.
Morning, Tommy.
Amazing. That car never ages.
To help keep your car young, protect your engine with Havoline Formula 3 motor oil. Add more life to your car.
What's it like to bite into a Wendy's Classic half-pound double with cheese? Man, this is weird. Wendy's, it's hamburger bliss.
Today there are over 300 Red Roof Inns. We've renovated our rooms, brighter colors, better fixtures, but kept our rates as affordable as ever. How do we do it?
Cheap commercials. Call 1-800-THE-ROOF and save money like you mean it.
Welcome back, everybody. Dover Downs International Speedway in Delaware. Track cleanup winding down after Dave Marcus and an oil leak. Pit stops taking place. Tony Stewart is in. Bobby Labonte is in. Mark Martin. Let's watch this over. See Stewart on the right of your screen. He's all the way still halfway down pit road. Martin. Stewart's got him. Ralph, impressive pit stops.
Yes, it sure was, Eli. A 17.8 second stop for Tony Stewart. They came in first, went back out first. They didn't want to make a whole lot of changes to the car. Tony really likes the way that it is right now. Says it's a little tight, but he likes it tighter than looser right now. They asked Tony, is there anything else we can get you? He said, yes, chocolate shake and fries. I'm starving. Steve?
Hey, Ralph, Mark Martin's pit stop. They took a half a pound of air out of the right rear tire, otherwise a four tire stop. And they put on a set of scuffed tires. Dick and Buddy mentioned that earlier about the teams putting scuffs on, getting them scuffed in during happy hour yesterday. And the 88 was the only car to put on sticker tires, Glenn Jarrett.
Okay, thanks, Steven. Down here, Bobby Labonte's pit. His car has been a little tied up off the corner, so they made a track bar adjustment and took a couple of rounds of bite out, put four tires of fuel. Let's bring closure to the Rusty Wallace situation. He did make it down pit road. He didn't run out of fuel. The reason he was running short on gas on the first green flag stop, Rusty's gas man fell down when he went across the wall. So therefore, he got the nozzle in late. They didn't get all the gas out of the can. They came up a little over 2 gallons short. That's why Rusty was experiencing that feeling of being out of gas or being close to out of gas. He darn near was.
Indeed so. But he's out there running. Pit road has been closed again now. As you see, talking about running, the gas fill-up area, the Unical station, is in the Busch Series garage. So those guys who want to go get those fill-up cans refilled are having a long, long run. They've closed pit roads again. They've got to do some more blowing of that speedy dry.
Eli, you see how slow the cars are running around there, and you see them wiggling back and forth. Yeah. What they're doing is they're getting the excess rubber and debris that you pick up on the tire surface off, getting them clean, and you're also putting a little heat into the running surface of the tire, so when you do go back to green, the tire will be ready to race.
As we go to break again while they continue cleanup, here's a trivia quiz question for you folks at home. Might want to mull it over as we have a rookie leading right now here at Dover. What was the last NASCAR Winston Cup Series race won by a rookie? Think about it. I'll give you a hint. It happened at this very racetrack. Think about it. We'll give you the answer later.
I know.
Time to get washed. Daddy's almost home. Honey, can you wash your feet? Hey, I hear Daddy.
Hey, guys!
Hi. Hey,
honey.
Okay, let's eat.
Hey, where are the fries?
What, no fries? I can't believe Daddy forgot the fries. I'll go get some more. Some.
Hurry back. Fry breath.
Did somebody say McDonald's?
Hey!
What are you doing up here?
So, you've been using 10-10-3-2-1?
What? Oh, I keep forgetting about that.
Well, you should try to remember. You get 50% off calls over 10 minutes, every day, anytime.
Oh, I like that. But there's got to be a monthly fee, right?
Not with 10-10-3-2-1. Dial it, and you'll see the savings on your phone bill.
All right. I'll give it a try.
Cool.
Hey, get away from my car!
Just dial 10-10-3-2-1.
Today on TNN Motorsports, it's bench racing at its best with some of stock car racing's legends.
Hell, he ran into me on last lap over the third turn and bumped me up out of the way.
Yeah, I had hit you a time or two that day. My car was handling so bad.
Two people in here is Kale hit.
Don't miss Stock Car Legends Reunion today after the race at 4:30 Eastern on TNN Motorsports.
Hey, folks, coming up as soon as we move aside after the race, it is maybe the best bench racing you've ever enjoyed. You'll hear some hilarious stories told by 20 of Stock Car Racing's greats. Lots of fun coming up next on Stock Car Legends Reunion. It is right here on TNN Motorsports. Ken Squire and I had the pleasure of being the moderators. Although, buddy, you were there. I think after a while, we kind of became referees.
Yeah, it was so much fun, though, to get all the guys together. And the late Dick Beatty, it was one of the last things that we got to do together. He used to be the inspector for NASCAR here. And it means a lot to sit down with David Pearson and Cale Yarborough. Of course, we kind of hammered on Cale a little bit, but he needed it.
He did. I said, all right, who in this room hasn't been hit by Cale Yarborough? No hands went up in the air. All right, the last rookie to win in NASCAR Winston Cup racing. Folks at home, you probably have your guess. The last rookie to win a NASCAR Winston Cup, Davey Allison, the late Davey Allison, won right here at Dover in May of 1987. It was his second win of that year. Those of you might remember, he won at Talladega in May of that year and then won here later that same month in that number 28 Texaco Haviland Ford. Davey's first win, his 14th career start. That's how quickly he won. And last time a rookie won, and Tony Stewart would love to add his name to a list that includes Davey Allison on it.
I would give anything to see Tony Stewart, Davey Allison, guys go at it. What a piece of the history book was torn out there when Davey Allison lost his life.
He would have been so rich for the sport if he had lived.
Yeah, I'd give anything to see Davey Allison walk back into the racetrack. No doubt about that. But that is the man who is carrying the torch right now as a rookie in NASCAR Winston Cup Series racing. His name, Tony Stewart. And he's had a lot of successes here at Dover. In the NASCAR Busch Series, he ran that shell machine. In the Indy Racing League, he ran here as well in July of a year ago and turned some blistering speeds. Very much at home in any type of motorized vehicle, Tony Stewart.
Every time I talk to him, I say, what's the difference in the Indy car and the Winston Cup car? He said, well, in the Winston Cup car, when you win, you can pump your hand in the air for a sign of victory. He said, you do that in the Indy car, you knock a wing off the back.
If you folks are just tuning in, there are some of the numbers regarding today's race. And this caution is, again, if you're just joining us, Dave Marcus had a problem with an oil leak on the car a couple of times. To his credit, he got the car down and off the racetrack as quickly as he could, but not before it left literally a whole pool of oil around the racetrack and down the pit lane. So finally, the field is going to get the one-to-go signal now. They have just about wrapped up. I mean, they have used a season's worth of oil dry, getting things ready. You can see up and down pit road still. Crews are making sure all is cleaned up, but we're set to go in one more mile. There's Jeff Gordon. He's fifth right now, Steve, on the restart.
Hey, Eli, on the first pit stop, we showed everybody the spring rubber that they took out of the right front. And Buddy Baker talked about that early in the race, how the cars will roll over on that right front. Well, they loosened him up all right. They loosened him up too much. So on this most recent pit stop, they decided to tighten it up a little bit. They took a half round out of the right rear to tighten him back up.
So that's the story on the Jeff Gordon machine as Ray Evernham and the bunch getting him back to go racing. Right now, we have a grand total of 10 cars on the lead lap. I mean, it's just been one of those days when Mark Martin led from lap 4 through 93. He put most of the world a lap down. Then when Tony Stewart took over at lap 95 and then reassumed the lead at lap 114, the guys that Mark hadn't disposed of, he pretty much did. You know, we've seen that at Dover over the years. If it goes green for a lengthy period, there's a real distinct difference here between the haves and the have-nots.
Yeah, and last year there was only five cars at the end of the race in the same lap.
Go.
There's that young fan here who is an aspiring flag man and always mimics exactly what Rodney Wise and Jimmy Howell do atop the flag stand. All right, back to work. Tony Stewart. Tail end of the lead lap, just couldn't do it.
A lot of pressure on Kenny Irwin. Story in USA Today a week or so ago. Robert Yates was quoted as saying that he just absolutely, his heart goes out for this team. They so desperately want to win, but they just have not had things go their way. One of the two teams for Yates is leading the points. The other one is 22nd in points. One has nine top fives. This team has one. And it's not for lack of trying, let me guarantee you. It's not for lack of skill either.
And only once this year has Kenny Irwin led an event. He led 32 laps in the Primestar 500. Other than that, he has not been at the head of the field. But you're right, not due to lack of trying or lack of talent.
Tony
Stewart comes right back, and here comes Labonte for the lead. The 28's on the tail end of the lead lap, and the 18, Bobby Labonte, takes over the lead.
You know, you hear people say, well, why'd he do that? He's out there trying to win the race, Kenny Irwin Jr. If he gets back in the lead lap, gets that car dialed in, he has a right to race as hard as he can to try to get back in the lead lap.
So Bobby Labonte, the new leader at lap 179. Mark Martin is 3/10 of a second back, not even that much. Martin running in third. Got Jerry Nadeau right there in the mix. He's in 26th, a couple of laps down, but was trying to get back one of his two laps. Couldn't do it, but that's why the 9 car is up there in that mix.
Irwin's hanging tough. He's got that lap back, and he is just going to stay there if he possibly can.
Bobby Labonte says, I'm going to sit here and ride with him if we drive away from everybody else right now.
Well, Irwin's running well. Why not?
Riding with Kenny Irwin. Say, right there coming off the corner is where Bobby Labonte has really had a lot of get up and go in that Pontiac of his.
He and Tony Stewart both. You can hear him get back to front and listen.
But 28 is locking for no horsepower. He's got as good a motor as Bobby Labonte has for sure. Even though Robert Yates has changed the engine combination a little bit on the 28 and 88, changed it for a little bit more reliability. Cost him a little horsepower, but they're looking at the big picture.
Check it out, though. That's new tires on there. Let's see who's really strong after the tires really get warm and they start to lose a little grip. Then the fast cars show up there.
There's a good third-place scramble there. Mark Martin has it. Rusty Wallace next. Then Jeff Gordon next in line. That green and yellow John Deere car for Chad Little, he is a couple of laps down back in 27. But Kenny Wallace in the 55 is right behind there. That blue and yellow square D car, he's battling for position.
Absolutely. Having a great run today. Kenny Wallace really needed this because a lot of people said he had the qualifying down. As the race goes, he always drops back. But right now, he's showing a lot of muscle.
Well, he's got one of those Andy Petrie motors under the hood. They're using a T&L to qualify with, but he's got a Petrie motor under the hood. And he says, why didn't I have equipment like this for the last 5 years? Look at this.
He's going to challenge Jeff Gordon for the spot.
Yeah, he's going to get him. Well, maybe.
Kenny Wallace qualified third and finished 12th at Charlotte. Remember last year for Kenny Wallace here? Oh. Last year, one race ended with an accident on lap 32 for him. Then the fall race ended with engine failure on lap 2. I mean, he ran 36 miles in two races here, that's all. Here's a good battle there, not for position because Bill Elliott's a lap down.
I think Jeff Gordon's got a little bit of a handling problem right now. I can't really tell what it is, but several cars have been able to pass him on the outside. You hardly ever see that on this racetrack with Jeff Gordon.
Well, the problem they've had with the car is inconsistency. It'll be fast, and then it's not so fast. Right now, it looks pretty good going on the bottom to pass Rusty Wallace.
Like I say, as the tires get worn, then you find out who has a great setup. But I'm really impressed with Kenny Wallace's run today. He's doing a great job in the number 55, the yellow and blue car going down.
Yeah, his career best finish ever was a fourth at Martinsville in 1994. He could better that today.
He had a sixth at Martinsville. So he's done well. Time. This is ninth place. There you see Jeff Burton. Earnhardt not on the lead lap. Then you see Dale Jarrett behind, and Jarrett is on the lead lap. Now third place again. Gordon wants to grab it back from Wallace. Gordon in the 24. Outpowers him in the turn three. Platinum 400 live on TNN Motorsports.
I would say Ray Evernham is going up and down with tire pressure on the 24. It seems as the tire pressures get up, as the tire gets hotter, that 24 gets faster and faster.
Yeah, let's remember that as the race wears on, that that team has a history of doing better and better. It's not where these guys start, it's where they finish, and they are absolute masters at adjusting a race car so that by the end, it's quick. Did you see Gordon's head out the window?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's directing traffic from behind the wheel.
Did you see that? Just stuck his head out the window and said, let's do it.
Yeah.
He's probably saying thank you for giving me racing room there to allow traffic.
At 145 miles an hour.
Yeah.
To do that in open wheel cars, didn't you? I saw one where you had your arm out, but you're upside down.
Yeah. Let's get back to the race here at Dover, buddy.
All the while, Bobby Labonte still leads by 9/10 of a second over Tony Stewart. All right, let's see what this hand signal was about. Watch Gordon.
He's telling the Chad Little he's going to the bottom side of the racetrack. You see him cut over right there.
Boy, he might have been signaling to Kenny Wallace, try and follow me.
Well, but you see the green car on the left side where he put his hand out. He said, I'm going to go to the bottom of the racetrack, give me a little room, and exactly what Chad Little did.
Now the battle for seventh. Skinner. Jeff Burton.
Hey, don't do that.
The cat car, Ward Burton, is behind that, but he's not on the lead lap. He's in 13th, the lap down.
Well, tight traffic there.
Only 10 cars on the lead lap. As he rides with Jeff Burton. Get that pedal to the metal sweepstakes, folks. You want to make a note of who's leading this race in five laps from now. Chance to qualify to win those big prizes we talked about earlier.
Ricky Rudd, Dale Earnhardt, many times here they raced each other for the win here.
And that is the position. They are running 14th and 15th, but they too, like most everybody else, will lap down.
And Burton's in it as well. He is running 13th right now in the number 22 car. Skinner in the 31 is ninth.
Mike Skinner's hanging on right now. He's running a very high line around the racetrack. It looks to be just a little bit off of Larry McReynolds' wheel dial that car, and it'll come back as a strong race car somewhere along the straight.
Excuse me, says Mr. Earnhardt. Ward Burton moves up the speedway. Well, now we got team cars side by side.
And Earnhardt is 13.
Yeah, they work on them in the same part of the country, but as far as team cars, I've never seen them on the racetrack. You'll see the one of them before. They race each other as hard as they do anyone else.
Ralph, Earnhardt seems to be getting around pretty well.
Eli, if you remember the beginning of the race, he made an early pit stop because the car was so bad. They've been working on it all day. The car is getting better. The shocks are still not right. He's got a very bad vibration with the shocks. Beating them up pretty good. You know how bumpy it is going across the cement, even though it's smooth, still fairly rough.
Thoughts out of the Dale Earnhardt pit area as we close it at halfway, and across the stripe comes that man, Bobby Labonte. So he leads at halfway in the MBNA Platinum 400. We're back to Dover Downs in a moment.
Hi, I'm Jeff Burton with an exciting message for NASCAR fans. Buy any Exide NASCAR Select product and get a Motorola pager free. It's a great way to enter the Exide NASCAR Select 99 sweepstakes. Every month you'll be paged with another chance to win cool prizes. You could even win $50,000 and be an honorary member of the Exide Racing Team pit crew for the first race of the next century. Look for details wherever Exide NASCAR Select is sold.
Holy cow, man, I gotta find a phone.
Rogaine Extra Strength has proven to work for 4 out of 5 men.
I like my chances.
Only Rogaine has extra strength, and it's proven to stop hair loss or regrow hair. Rogaine Extra Strength, proven to work.
You got feet that sweat for a living, and you get athlete's foot. Smart guys know comfort comes in yellow. New improved Desinex powder, it gets rid of the fungus and absorbs twice as much moisture as tenactin. Desinex soothes while it cures for comfortable feet.
You have your weekend projects. We have ours.
Talking rugged, we're talking fun. You ride the best and the job gets done. Well, Larry's ATV are made in the USA. We're talking tough.
56. 56.
Buy a new Polaris ATV now with payments as low as $56 a month. See your Polaris dealer for details.
Polaris ATV, we're talking tough.
TNN Motorsports live coverage of the MBNA Platinum 400 is being brought to you by the Home Depot, the official home improvement warehouse of NASCAR. Buy Desinex for athlete's foot. It soothes while it cures. And by Polaris ATVs. If you're going to ride, ride the best Polaris. Hey, you're just back in time. We've got a good battle for the lead shaping up again. Bobby Labonte has had the advantage, but Tony Stewart's turned it up just a tick.
Tony Stewart on long runs is extremely fast. You can see him working his hands now as he heads down toward turn one. Look how still his hands are as he goes in the corner. That car is really working right on the bottom of the racetrack as he closes in on Bobby Labonte.
Derek Cope, the 30, is five laps down. And there it goes. Tony Stewart takes the lead at lap 208.
Ooh, yow. Boy, that car's strong.
Yeah.
Ooh. It is. And as we watch Derek Cope's car, we'd like to say hello to Marion Ryder, Chuck Ryder's mom, 86 years old, ailing at this moment. We wish you well, Marion.
Definitely so. Another easy pass took place a few moments ago. Watch this change for third spot. Jeff Gordon coming through.
Mark will do that. Right now he just outfielded his car up to speed. He just pulled over and let Jeff go.
We're at lap 209. The leaders last pitted on lap 169. By the way, Dave Marcus is back again. Don't remember if I mentioned that to you folks. He is back on the track again. 66 laps down. As you see, NASCAR timing and scoring brought to you by NAPA. NASCAR also just radioed into the garage area. They said, anybody still there in that 33 garage stall? Kenny Schrader, who went out of lap number 6, and the response came, yep, they're still rebuilding the race car. If they can get out for 100 laps, they're going to do so.
So Schrader's still here.
Schrader's still here.
Okay, good.
Yeah, so those of you wondering about Kenny, we've not forgotten him. They're just still rebuilding that car after the accident on lap number 6.
That kind of work builds character also. Once you get that never die situation in the race team, you can go on from there. So that's what they're doing. They're building a lot of character, even though they can't win anything.
You just see that shot. Look at that. You got a paper napkin. You got a plastic Glenn, is there concern? I just noticed this garbage on the front of Rusty Wallace's car.
Absolutely, Eli. They're cautioning him to watch the temperature gauges each and every lap, particularly the water temperature and also the oil temperature. They're really concerned that this is going to heat things up. It's going to affect the way the car drives, too. It could tend to make the car have a little more downforce. Not as much air going through it creates more downforce. Could make the car a little bit looser. They've got Rusty on top of it. Also, let me tell you about points leader Dale Jarrett. They made a track bar adjustment on the car on that last pit stop, and his car is extremely loose. And I can tell you one thing about DJ, he does not like a loose race car. Right now, his lap times are about a half a second slower than what they were before they made the adjustment. So they definitely seem to have gone the wrong way.
Glenn, just watching him go through the corner, you're exactly right. The back of that car is about 2 feet hung out as he goes through the corner. That's not a very pleasant thing. What you're doing is steering into the slide all the time and afraid to get back in the throttle real hard, because if you do, you'll break the rear wheels loose and the car will turn around in front of all this traffic cars.
I'll leave the tires up in a hurry as well. This is not a good situation that Dale Jarrett is facing at the moment.
Jarrett's running ninth right now. Jeff Burton is running eighth, and you see how those numbers will be reflected atop the NASCAR Winston Cup Series point standings.
I think Neil Bonnett used to talk about pushing loose about as well as anybody. He used to say, if it's pushing, you see the wreck.
Kyle right making a pit stop at lap number 216. Glenn?
Well, they've gone to the right side of Kyle Petty's car, guys, and evidently they've got a tire going down. I saw the crew getting ready. I was on my way up there to try to find out, and Kyle came down pit road. They're on the right side. He's down and away. So obviously they either had a vibration or a tire going down. I'll check on it and update you.
Tough break for Kyle Petty, who had qualified well, was looking forward to a fine finish here. Last time he had a top five finish was this race 2 years ago when he finished third. He thought maybe today would have been his day.
Call it a bonanza, an extravaganza. It's how you save on tires. Now at Pep Boys, all 35,000-mile tires are four for only $99, and all 70,000-mile tires, four for $169.
Pep Boys, cars like us,
people love us.
The scent of exhilaration from Aquavelva, now available in new skin conditioning gel.
This is a sport that brings families together. Most of the time, anyway.
You're mine today, buddy. That rooster's crowing a little early this morning, isn't it?
This is a sport where the hearts race every bit as fast as the cars. And this is a sport where some of its biggest fans are some of its smallest. This is NASCAR.
Hey, look, the oil came right out.
The Pocono 500, June 20th at 1 Eastern on TNN.
Hi, I'm Jim Examus, and at Jim Examus Ford Lincoln Mercury in Lincoln, we don't just scream great deal or great price, but we do yell about the great service during and after your purchase by people who care. Here, let me show you. Jim Examus Ford Lincoln Mercury in Lincoln, where every day is a sale day, and our service makes the difference. And by the way, the smiles are free.
There's a place deep in the heartland where 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, people who think they'd never get a car are getting a car loan over the phone. It's Auto Hotline USA, one of the country's best sources for auto loans. Bankruptcy, recently divorced, bad credit, even no credit is no problem at Auto Hotline USA. Call 1-800-748-8093. That's 800-748-8093. 24 hours a day, 7 days a week to get an auto loan on your touchtone phone.
Well, we promised we'd give you the address again to enter the TNN Pedal to the Metal Sweepstakes. The leader at halfway today was Bobby LaFonte. And you could win that grand prize of a Ford F-150 4x4 pickup truck or the first prize trip to one of an upcoming NASCAR Winston Cup Series races that's going to be aired right here on TNN. Just write down on that postcard Bobby LaFonte's name along with your name, your age, address, phone number, and make sure you write down the leader at halfway, Bobby Labonte, and the address. As you saw, TNN Pedal of the Metal Sweepstakes, TNN Station, P.O. Box 3582, Southbury, Connecticut, and that is the man we are riding with right now, Bobby Labonte. Driver of the Interstate Batteries Pontiac, and look at Jeff Gordon right there. He's caught him. They're a second and a half behind Tony Stewart. Well, Mr. Gordon's got himself dialed in.
Indeed, dialed in is the right word because in the happy hour he was 21st quick,
yeah.
14th quick in the third practice. That's the practice that they took with the race setup, and he qualified 14th. And look at here, he is running in second spot, a much stronger car than he's had all weekend long.
The big question that everybody wants to know is why the open wheel drivers do such a great job in Winston Cup cars. And they said the first thing you can do is run right against the wall with open wheel cars. You respect the wall. You learn to pinpoint your way through traffic because you can't afford to touch anything. So you get really precise in your driving. And if you see Jeff Gordon right now, he's chasing Tony Stewart, two of the best.
Now let's look at 1.2 seconds. Here comes Tony Stewart down low right there. Thought about bypassing Skinner. Skinner's in 10th, so if Stewart gets by him, he'd put him a lap down. And now let's go back 1.258 seconds to the 24 car, but again, there's traffic to negotiate. Kevin LePage, Joe Nemechek, Robert Presley's car there, so
we could have add one more thought as to why these open wheel drivers are so good, and that is there are so many midweek open wheel races in this country that many of them get to run 3, 4, 5, 6 nights a week if they want to do it. And Gordon did that, and so did Tony Stewart. So as young race car drivers in this league, they have an awful lot of experience behind them.
You know what I'm happy to see, too, is a guy like Dave Blaney start to do well in NASCAR Busch Series racing and stepping up to some NASCAR Winston Cup, because the Pennzoil World of Outlaws guys are outstanding drivers. But we saw the Kinzer experiment didn't necessarily pan out in NASCAR. Those guys are darn good racers. It's nice to see Dave Blaney making an impact.
Absolutely, man. As you were talking about some of the guys that tried it, they didn't have the time to really get, you know, like Tony Stewart, he went in, he ran Busch Grand National for a year, then he gets into a car that Bobby Labonte and Jimmy Maycar really added to the production of that car, so he's blessed to have a teammate like he has. That really took about 2 years of learning off him.
Of course, you know, Steve Kinzer, he's not a better race car driver in the world than him. It just didn't work out.
He just didn't have enough time. Yeah. Neither did Sammy Swindell.
Right.
Both of those men could have been great Winston Cup drivers had they enough opportunity here and enough laps.
Starting to see pit stops again for some, those on the early fringes. Bobby Hamilton is in now at lap 231 as we ride with Robert Presley. Let's see how the numbers crank up as we check out the telemetry here. 8,200 RPM.
Brother Charlie Presley's now working on that race car. Brother driving it, crew chief.
Got up to 8,300 RPM that time. They really just burnt that throttle is all.
Yeah, when they go down in the corner, you hear them out right there. Halfway through the corner, they let it roll there and then ride easy back in the throttle.
Well, there you see on the left of your screen, Tony Stewart. On the right, Jeff Gordon. That's first and second. Yeah, the Good Humor Man is here. 90-degree day, doing a big business.
Okay, listen. At hairpin turn 6, keep it at 250 to slingshot you onto the straightaway. We'll see what happens.
The loop can get real tricky, so hold your line when you're upside down.
And remember, after you hit the jump, ease off the air brake. When you're pulling 5G, handles like a jet.
Race without limits.
Did I mention the oncoming traffic?
In the racing business, the right hardware at the right time can make the difference between winning and losing.
Try True Value, where you're always a winner, with the right hardware at the right time and at the right price.
Your True Value is the official hardware store of NASCAR, IROC, and Homes Everywhere.
Ever since Mobil 1 came along, other oil companies have tried to copy it to make a synthetic of their own. But if you take a look at how a copycat performs after some hard miles and compare it to new Mobil 1, it's obvious that all synthetics aren't alike. Today's Mobil 1 is tri-synthetic. It won't sludge up on you. It'll actually make your engine run smoother. The other stuff, not in my car.
Nothing outperforms Mobil 1.
I never thought when my son moved away that I wouldn't see him for 3 years. Just a tractor for my grandson. But this trip I wasn't gonna miss.
He's sleeping.
This is for when he's older. My son had built his own life.
Hey, Dad.
He got a John Deere.
Of course.
But he still appreciates where he came from.
The LT-133 from John Deere. At under $2,000, it's possibly the best lawn tractor ever built. And it's the only one with a past as bright as its future.
We are back. Only 9 cars on the lead lap, but 2 of them, Tony Stewart, the leader, and Jeff Gordon, are separated by only 1 second. Jeff Gordon has chopped off a couple of tenths on Tony Stewart's lead. Of course, David Green, the buffer car between the two.
Yeah, as they go through the corners there, Tony Stewart looks to be running quite well, but they've done something to that race car of Jeff Gordon's to balance it out. They were complaining of it being too tight at the first of the race. Then they said they over-adjusted, made it too loose. Right now, I don't know of one thing they could do to that race car to make it better.
If you're just tuning in, the cars on the lead lap are Tony Stewart, Jeff Gordon, Bobby Labonte is third, Mark Martin fourth, Kenny Wallace super running fifth, Jeremy Mayfield doing well in sixth, Rusty Wallace is seventh, Jeff Burton is eighth, and Dale Jarrett ninth. Those nine cars are on the lead lap. By the way, I haven't talked much about Rick Mast today. Rick is running in 21st position. He's a couple of laps back in the Guess Who car. It says, ha, 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 Guess Who?
We know, but we can't
we
say.
We know, but we can't say. But they have a brand new sponsor, all signed, sealed, and delivered, which they're going to debut next weekend in Michigan. And they just weren't ready to get it going this weekend. So he said, we'll just tease everybody and put Guess Who on the car. Ha, 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 ha. And that's what it says. We'll all find out together publicly next week.
What did he just say?
It says, Guess Who? Ha, 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 ha. You see all those ha's there on the car. Ha, ha, ha.
Yeah, and that's supposed to be the clue. The
that's
ha,
ha, ha, ha. It is the clue, yeah. Yes.
Okay, enough said on that one. Yes.
Huh. Ha, ha. But we'll all find out next weekend in Michigan what Rick Mast has in store. But it should be a good deal for them running 21st today. Couple of laps down to our race leader, Tony Stewart. That's sixth place. That's a good scramble. Make it seventh right now. Seventh for Burton and eighth for Rusty Wallace. And still got those wrappers on the front of Rusty's car. You're looking back there onto that Taurus.
And you know, you're talking about crews that have done a lot of hard work. You look at that Ford Taurus. That thing was wrecked on Sunday night at Charlotte Motor Speedway. Crews stripped the body off it, had it ready for the paint shop by 2 o'clock in the afternoon on Monday. By midnight, the new body was back on it again. The frame had been straightened, the frame had been sectioned, and the guys were painting it all in one day.
And it's running a lot better now that they've done all the work on it this week than it did at Charlotte last week. Rusty was not pleased with the way the car ran, but apparently it's not running hot right now. With all that paper on the front, you would suspect that it would probably be running 15, 20 degrees hotter than normal when it has all that air opening there on the front.
That is fourth position. Battling for seventh. Dale Jarrett's right in that mix also. That's seventh, eighth, and ninth. Then the Paychecks car behind him, that's Brett Bodine. He is not on the lead lap. As a matter of fact, Brett's about a dozen laps down now in 39th position. Good scramble up.
Yeah, Dale Jarrett looks very, very quick now. He's apparently got himself where he's gotten used to the loose condition he was complaining about, or even the racetrack coming to him, because he's moving forward again.
They're about 15 seconds behind the leader, Tony Stewart. So they're still 8-9 seconds away from being lapped, which is obviously significant.
Pretty close there, coming out of the corner.
Glenn, it's tough to tell who's got the best car in that bunch.
Well, all those cars are very, very loose. Rusty has been complaining about the number two Miller Lite car for the last 15, 20 laps or so, talking about how loose it is. Of course, we told you Dale Jarrett was loose a while ago, and Jeff Burton's car is not much better. If you go on up, they're about 15 and a half seconds behind the leader right now, with pit stops coming up in about 10 laps. If you go on up to Mark Martin, who was so dominant early on, he's about almost four seconds behind right now, and his car is very, very loose. So all these cars went from being very, very tight to being real loose right now. So the adjustments they made, they're going to have to go back in the opposite direction now, try to snug them up a little bit, because these cars seem to be pretty loose on new tires. So if they're loose on new tires, they better do something to them.
Starting up on pit stops now. We told you Bobby Hamilton was in a bit ago. You see Jeffrey Bodine with a pit stop. Front tire is the problem, so they'll make a four-tire change there at lap number 250 for Jeffrey Bodine. Right now it's Tony Stewart's race. It's still 150 miles to go.
I want to like Rebecca, I really do. But she thinks Miller Lite tastes great because it's smooth.
And Rick thinks it's because of the choice hops.
And even if we could get past that, we'd still argue over whose work sells the most sports magazines.
Okay, in-depth analysis of the nickel defense or fishnet bikinis. You decide.
Look, Rebecca, guys buy sports magazines for great sports writing.
Oh, great. So I guess we'll be seeing that Rick Riley sports writing calendar any day now.
Oh, man.
Miller Lite, the great taste of a true Pilsner beer.
We've heard your complaints about changing your oil filter, trying to grip that slippery filter. That's why Fram, America's number one filter, now has Sure Grip, a rough texture top for easy gripping and installing.
It makes changing your oil filter a lot easier.
This Father's Day, imagine how thrilled Dad will be to wake up to Mach 3. New from Gillette. Give him the best. The first triple blade razor for a shave he'll never forget. Mach 3 from Gillette.
Guess what's on TV Friday night?
It ain't that stuff you've been watching. It's car flying, tire spinning, bull riding, front busting, car crashing, truck smashing, fender bending, roller jamming, big time mega match action.
Or
car chasing, bull busting, engine revving, roller jamming, mega match and motor blowing, Friday night action. So turn on TNN and you won't need your remote control.
Welcome back, everybody. Dover Downs International Speedway in Delaware. We're just about an hour and 15 minutes of a drive without race traffic from the city of Philadelphia. Riding with Tony Stewart, the race leader. He is about to put the 18th place runner, Steve Park, another lap down, and he does. Now you'll see the 60 start going by, everybody. Jeffrey Bodine, remember, made a pit stop just before we went to a commercial break, and that's why he blows on past everyone.
Exactly. That's what new tires do. You look like Superman for about 15 laps, and then all of a sudden they get the heat built up in them, the air pressure goes up in them, and all of a sudden you're right back in getting laps again.
And then you start looking like Lois Lane.
Oh, yeah. Uh-oh. I'm not going there. Anyway. Anyway.
Wally Dahlenbach, he goes a second lap down in 17th spot, the 25 car. Pit stops for more teams now while you're watching the on-track action. They'll tell you Mike Skinner is in, Ernie Irvin is in, Terry Labonte is in. There's Mike Skinner's stop under the direction of crew chief Larry McReynolds. See where Larry Mack said that if he does get his team put together for next year, as he hopes, he's going to be his own crew chief.
Well, he should be. He's one of the best on pit road. Heck, he's one of the best there has ever been. He should be the crew chief.
There were no wedge adjustments on that car. They did it all with air pressure. If any changes they made on that car, they never put a wrench through the back window there to adjust the bike at all.
Tony Stewart pitted lap 169. That is 90 laps ago. There you see Terry Labonte. He just pitted. So he'll probably pass his brother here fairly quickly because Bobby's got the older tires going.
Bobby just moved over, let him go. He knows he's got fresh tires.
Now just behind him, though, Mark Martin does not. Those two are very close. Here comes Rusty Wallace down pit road.
All of these stops are under green. As a matter of fact, we have really only had one series of pit stops under caution. Here's a chance to get those hot dog wrappers off the grill of the car. Others in include Bill Elliott, David Green is coming down pit road, Ricky Craven is in.
There's Billy Wilburn on the front tires. He won a sprint car race just outside Charlotte last week. The newest winner in Penske South Racing.
More pit stops. Ward Burton is coming in. Ted Musgrave pits. All of these stops now lap 261. Jeremy Mayfield, here he comes in. Teammate to Rusty Wallace with a Penske South entry. This really is one of the risky periods. You see them pull off that film instead of washing the windshield. You just do a tear off and you've got your clean. This is a risky time because if a caution comes out now, a lot of guys are going to be in deep.
Yeah, you'll be a lap down no matter what. You'll lose another lap if you come in early. Dale Jarrett down pit road now, coming towards the pit.
Jeff Burton also in.
Jeff Burton, as you say, is also in. All of this lap 263, Glenn.
Yes, excuse me. I was up at Rusty Wallace. The gas man got hit by a lug nut there when he came in and made his pit stop, and they were sending him from running down now to Dale Jarrett's car. He's coming down pit road right now. And he, of course, he's changing the left side tires. The right side's already done. Both Rusty and Dale were fighting loose conditions. They're going to move the track bar back. I told you they made a track bar adjustment. They're going down on it. Three rounds, 18.0 seconds. The track bar adjusted, four tires of fuel, and DJ's back out. Try to tighten that car up. We'll go back and learn more about the gas man with Rusty Wallace. What happened when they let the jack down on the car? It hit, they let it right down on the lug nut. Rusty was spinning the tires, and he spun one of the lug nuts right into the guy's ankle. It's like a bullet hitting, man. It was, he went down like a sack of lead. So we'll get an update on it.
We'll get a word. Here comes Mark Martin now, running in fifth spot at this stage of the afternoon. He'll be making a stop at lap 265. Robert Presley's car came to pit road and stopped at his pit stall, and they're going to leave him there until everybody makes their stops. Here comes Bobby Labonte in as well.
And Kenny Wallace just behind him.
Ricky Rudd is stopping, and Chad Little is in. Back to Glenn. Now, while Glenn checks on the story, here comes Tony Stewart in, so Jeff Gordon taking the lead. Tony Stewart is going to pit at lap 267. Back downstairs.
And Bobby Labonte is in for a four-car change and a chassis adjustment. They made a chassis adjustment on the left rear. The car was a little bit loose up off the corner. He's down and away on a great pit stop under green. Kenny Wallace also changed four tires, and he's out. And now Tony Stewart.
And now Rick Mast has spun on the racetrack. Jeff Gordon is going to pit. There is no caution. There is no caution. And the Guess Who car with Rick Mast at a quick spin. Gordon now will pit at lap 268. Let's go to Steve Burns.
And Eli, Jeff Gordon had to slow a bit on pit road. Wally Dahlenbach was exiting pit road as he was coming on.
Well, he almost had a caution in the midst of all of that, but it did not happen. Kenny Irwin will make a pit stop now. All of these stops now at lap 269. Now time for a Sure Grip pit report brought to you by Fram Extra Guard, the only filter with the rough texture. Sure Grip top, Ralph.
Eli, the pit stop from Tony Stewart was just what they wanted. No changes again. Tony really likes the way the car is handling. They're not making any adjustments to the car at all. They put scuffed tires on it this time, fill it up with fuel, put gas in it, clean the grill, and send them back out.
All of these stops are under green. We're now at lap 269. New leader is going to be Johnny Benson for the first time today, because we are cycling around in pit stops here. And Johnny Benson, oh, problems again for Rick Mast after he comes down the pit lane. He can't continue on to his pit stall, so the crew out there tending to the car. And there is our race leader, Johnny Benson, and the Cheerios entry. This will be only the second race he has led this year. The first one was last week when he led one lap at Charlotte in the Coca-Cola 600. So after going for the whole season to this point without leading a race, Johnny Benson now leads for 2 weeks in a row, but here he will make a pit stop at 271, and that will cycle Jeff Gordon back around into the race lead. Glenn, let's get back to you. That injury down in the pits. Tell me more.
Okay, Eli, that was Bob Tracy, the gas man for Rusty Wallace, and I told you that he got hit by a lug nut. Also, I just, in the confusion there, I saw it happen, but when the guy changing the left rear tire finished, he dropped the gun, and the gun went up under the car, and so the gun spun back and hit Bob in the ankle also. I talked to Bob. He said he was hurting pretty bad, but Other than that, he was okay, but he does have some injuries to that ankle. They have put him on a stretcher and taken him to the infield hospital right now. But thank goodness he was okay, well enough to talk to us.
Definitely so. Well, you see Kyle Petty pitting, Johnny Benson coming out, the man in the middle of your picture, Jeff Gordon, is the race leader, but Tony Stewart wants it right back, the 20 car.
That's Ward Burton and the 22 on the high side. These two, everybody's been wondering who has the muscle, and we'll be able to tell now because that Jeff Gordon seemed to be the quickest car, along with Tony Stewart, of anybody out there. So it's going to be interesting after the tires wear a little bit as to who has the great setup.
And by the way, if you're a Kenny Schrader fan, yes, he is back. After that early race accident, Schrader is running 263 laps down. But he's out there earning whatever NASCAR Winston Cup points he can here at Dover.
Rock and roll!
We love you!
Rock! Rock and roll!
We love you!
All right! Rock and roll! We love you!
Keep your car rocking. Protect your engine with Havoline Formula 3 motor oil. Add more life to your car.
Move it. They're catching us.
You know, my first racing days were pretty rough. With my wheels set so close together, I was always getting loose in the turns. Now that I'm trading paint with the big boys, wider is better.
The White Track Grand Prix delivers precise control in the corners. No wonder it's been selected official pace car of NASCAR.
There's no getting around it. Wider is
better. Wider is better. Now you can take that to the bank with this winning offer on the White Track Grand Prix. See your local Pontiac dealer for details.
Angie, I was like, she should know 1-800-CALL-ATT is a guaranteed cheap collect call.
1-800-CALLATT.
Rabbit. Convertible.
Nothing drives like a Hummer. And right now, during Napa's big sale days, you can win a 1999 Hummer, a 52-inch RCA TV, or one of over 6,000 Coleman coolers. Plus, save on hundreds of items. Stop by a participating Napa Auto Parts store today.
This summer, if you can dream it up, Sonic can put it in a cup. We've got hundreds of drink flavors you can mix and match. Plus, our 44-ounce Route 44 big drinks. Enough choices to let your dreams run wild.
TNN Motorsports live coverage of the MBNA Platinum 400 is being brought to you by Napa Auto Parts. Napa, we keep America running. And by Sonic, where we invite you to drive in for a change. Well, there is the reason for our third caution of the day. Chad Little spinning in turn number two, right there with the leaders in sight. And he brings out the caution. Here's a bit of a view. You see the leader, Jeff Gordon.
You can see the smoke off of the tires as he spins up toward the wall. You know, I don't even believe he hit the wall. He come very close to hitting, but he righted the car and went right on. Look at the smoke there, and Jeff Gordon goes to the bottom side of the racetrack along with Tony Stewart, first and second place there.
Now we are going to see pit stops here at lap 280. Rusty Wallace is in, Dale Jarrett is in, Jeff Burton is going to pit. This is interesting because the pit window, fuel-wise, about 100 miles. So, Glenn, they're still going to be about 20 miles shy of the finish.
Well, the thing is, Eli, these are the two cars that went to tail end of the lead lap. They're going to be back there anyway with only nine cars on the lead lap. They're not really giving up much track position, and neither one of these guys were happy with the way their cars were handling. Remember, they made major adjustments, both Dale Jarrett and Rusty Wallace, on their cars the last time that they pitted, also Jeff Burton. So they're down and away right now, but this is just one extra chance for them to adjust that chassis and try to get closer to that lead bunch.
Be real interesting to see how it goes. You know, be interesting to see. He didn't really lose that much. Probably lost more was Kenny Wallace. He really got on the binders during that accident.
And he did a really good job of avoiding trouble there. Because there are so few cars in the lead lap, he really did lose a lot in terms of serial position, but a bunch of the lap cars got in front of him when that happened. But Kenny's got finishing on his mind.
Still nine cars on the lead lap, that is all. as Delaware native Rodney Wise, backed up by Jimmy Howell, work on the flag stand here at Dover.
On any road, in any kind of weather, you can find yourself out of luck with a flat tire. But not with this tire. Even with no air pressure, you keep driving to safety. Goodyear Aquasteel Run Flat. It could be the difference between finding yourself out of luck or finding the safe way home. Aquasteel Run Flat, only from Goodyear.
What's it like to bite into a Wendy's Classic half-pound double with cheese? Man, this is weird. Wendy's, it's hamburger bliss.
We deliver great quality, time after time.
Same with Super 8.
Every room is comfortable. And roomy.
Super 8.
Super 8. Life's great at Super 8.
Join CBS as NASCAR hits the road with concerts featuring today's hottest performers. Feel the rush of NASCAR Rock.
Stock Car Legends Reunion, today on TNN.
Menards is a cut above the rest. It's saving you money. Get your yard work done with help from Black & Decker. This electric trimmer is on sale, only $11.88 after rebate. A 2-horsepower electric edger, just $59.99 after rebate. Crescent or wedge concrete edgers can be set deep to create a border you can mow over the top of. On sale, 39 cents each. Get an edge on savings with help from Menards.
Save big money at Menards.
Accidents are a fact. They can happen at any time. If you have been hurt in an accident, you may have the right to collect money. Call the law offices of Warren Dance at 1-800-679-6868. Call them. They will act now. They don't get paid until they collect money for you. Call 1-800-679-6868 for a free visit. Call the law offices of Warren Dance, known to help injured people.
Over-the-road transit for this broadcast provided by Ryder Transportation Services. Welcome back, everybody. Eli Gold, Buddy Baker, Dick Bergren, Glenn Jarrett, Steve Burns, Ralph Shaheen. We're a lap away from going green, but Robert Presley won't be there to participate. You see him going to the garage. Brett Bodine's car has also gone to the garage area. And here we come to get the one-to-go signal. There you see who's where. Lead lap cars will run out after Jeremy Mayfield. Only those top nine are on the lead lap. Then you go to the cars a lap down through Jeffrey Bodine. Then you start going to the guys two and three and four laps down. Great look at Dover Downs International Speedway, sold out, 122,000 folks. Ralph Shaheen, I don't know if you were here when this place sat about 25 or 30,000, but this place has grown up.
You know, actually, Eli, this is the first time I've been to Dover for a NASCAR Winston Cup race. I came here with Dick Bergen for the IRL race last year. It is an impressive facility, and Tony Stewart's going to like it a whole lot if he can get the air pressure adjusted on his car. Right now, it's a little bit tight. They've been talking about it on the radio. Greg Zipidelli, the crew chief, says they might make a slight air pressure adjustment on the next set of tires. That will be the one that'll take them to the checkered flag, they hope, Glenn.
Okay, Ralph, the 88 and the 2 came in. Rusty Wallace came in first, and he put his car was still loose, put a pound of air pressure in the right front and a round of bite in it. And DJ Screw also put a pound in the right front, one out of the right rear, and a round of wedge. Here we go to green.
Coming out of turn number 4.
Go.
Rodney Wise waves the green. We're back at it.
just watching these cars go around. Mark Martin is always in striking distance. They complain that they're having a problem with this or that or whatever. But you see the third car right there, Mark Martin, one of the most deliberate drivers. And we're riding with him down the back straightaway. Listen to his race car.
Nice and smooth, isn't he?
To a driver, that sound is like Pavarotti in concert.
Well, Pavarotti either. They're both good. I tell you what, though, he's getting the job done right now. The car's running quite well. He's right on the back bumper of Tony Stewart. Back in the back, though, hey, it's always a war back there.
There you see Rusty Wallace running in sixth in car number two. Anything more on his crew member, Glenn?
Bob Tracy was the, as I said, was the gas man, and it did break some bones in the top of his right, I believe it was his right foot, yeah. And so on the next caution flag, they're going to transport him out of here.
Oh, so trouble in the back stretch. Kenny Wallace got nailed.
Hard, get in front of him. Slow down, slow down, slow down.
Kenny was running sixth. Caution on the speedway.
What a shame. Yep. He had driven his heart out all day long. The car looked so very good. But that back straightaway is so narrow, it's easy to get in contact with another car.
And it looked as if that's just what happened, that there was contact with another car. What a disappointment for Kenny Wallace.
I'll tell you something. We have seen some major league hits here this weekend with Jeff Fuller yesterday in the NASCAR Busch Series race, and that was not an easy tag of the wall right there. None of them are.
Look at how out of line that car is. The whole rear end is pushed over to the left.
Well, the track bar is broke, and the whole rear end housing moved over to the left there.
Well, let's see if we can get an eyeball on what happened here on the backstretch.
Okay, the 55 there, Jeremy Mayfield, right under him as they come out of the corner there.
Oh, Kenny bounced off the wall.
A little bit of contact there.
Yep. He did. Kenny hit the wall first.
Kenny bounced off the wall first.
Yeah, into Jeremy Mayfield, and that turned him around down the back straightaway. See Steve Park and several other cars. Very, very lucky he stayed on the low side.
Watch it again. Bam. Just the least little bit.
But that's all it took.
Yep. Now, guys, we're 100 and it'll be 109 miles from the finish. Everybody's coming in again. Lap 291. Fuel, can they go 109 miles? Mm-hmm. Can you stretch it? Ralph?
Tony Stewart is in, Eli. They don't think they can go all the way from here. They are going to try to make that air pressure adjustment. They will put scum tires back on the race car again, and then they hope that this will be the right set of tires. He was just a little tight coming off the corners in 3 and 4. Steve?
And Ralph, Jeff Gordon just took 4 scuff tires as well. No chassis adjustments that we could see. Just 4 scuff tires and as much gasoline as they can get. Let's go to Glenn Jarrett.
And a drag race out of the pits. It looks like Mark Martin beat Bobby Labonte out. Labonte's crew put the fuel and 4 tires on. A very slight air pressure adjustment. They had tried to tighten the car up last time. It looks like Mark Martin may have beat him out for the position.
And looks as though Tony Stewart's going to get in line in 4th.
Yeah, he was way back up the pit road there, and he really didn't get very good position going back out on the racetrack. He dropped all the way to 4th spot.
So, caution after Kenny Wallace tags the wall. Dale Jarrett and Jeff Burton did not pit while the others did.
Guys, I'm coming in.
What is it, Mike? Is it too loose?
No, it's my kitchen. I want to remodel, but I don't know where to start.
What?
Dave, you're the kitchen guy. Get in here.
Okay, here's what you do. First,
when it comes to home improvement, there's no better team to work with than Team Lowe's. Lowe's, proud sponsor of Winston Cup Team number 31 and his World Championship pit crew.
Hey, Larry, let me talk to that kitchen guy again.
It's for you.
I've been everywhere, man. Across the desert, bare man.
If the technology of SuperGuard Motor Oil can protect these high-performance engines, imagine how it'll perform in your new Ford Taurus SHO. Visit our website, citgo.com, and you can win a 1999 Ford Taurus SHO or one of 500 other valuable prizes when you play the SuperGuard Online 500 Racing Challenge. Register to win at citgo.com.
I've been everywhere.
Things that make you go,
break it down.
The crispy, juicy chicken sandwich at Burger King. At just 99 cents, the taste isn't the only thing that makes you go.
your way. It just tastes better.
Call it a bonanza, an extravaganza. It's how you save on tires. Now at Pep Boys, all 35,000-mile tires are four for only $99, and all 70,000-mile tires, four for $169.
Pep Boys, cars like us.
People love us.
Rogaine Extra Strength is proven to work for four out of five men.
I like my chances.
Only Rogaine has extra strength, and it's proven to stop hair loss or regrow hair. Rogaine Extra Strength, proven to work.
Welcome back, everybody. Riding around the Dover Downs 1 mile with Elliott Sadler on the Wood Brothers Citgo machine. Elliott in 31st position right now, about four laps down. Reason we're under caution again was this problem on the backstretch. Kenny Wallace touches the wall, bangs into Jeremy Mayfield. And around she goes. Tough, tough way for Kenny's afternoon to wind up, because he was running in the top five all day long. Now a Sure Grip pit report brought to you by Fram Extra Guard, the only filter with the rough textured Sure Grip top. What are you hearing, Ralph? 109 miles, yay or nay?
Well, Eli, here's the first thing to take note. This caution flag is going to be a little bit longer than normal because they're going to get the ambulance out of the infield. Remember, there are no tunnels or bridges out of the infield here, and they want to get Rusty Wallace's injured crew member out of the infield to get proper medical care at a local hospital. So that's going to buy these teams another lap or two under yellow. So let's check with crew chief Greg Zipadelli. Is this going to be a long enough caution period for you to get to the end with this last stop, or do you need more?
I don't think so. We're still 2-3 laps short of it. I don't think it's enough to make a difference for us.
How much will you need?
We need another 2-3 laps.
Steve?
Well, Ralph, I just checked with Ray Evernham, asked him the same question on the 24 car. Ray said it's going to be close. It depends on how many caution laps they get here. So you're exactly right. The longer this caution period, the better it is for the 24. What do you have, Glenn Jarrett?
Okay, well, Dale Jarrett elected to stay out that time because he had just pitted, and they felt like if they could not make it anyway from 109, 107 laps that they were going to have. I came up, Rusty Wallace came in and took gas only. I just asked Robin Pemberton if they could make it. He gave me this sad look and said, nope, no way, we got to come back in.
Now, Bobby Labonte has just pitted again at lap 293. As you see, the ambulance taking Bob Tracy to the local hospital here. Tracy, again, the Rusty Wallace crew member who suffered an ankle injury and a suspected broken bone in the course of a tire change. So they'll have to close up the gates, and we'll go racing in a moment.
This is an extraordinary little device, this is. It places your data on a seamless global network, the only global network owned by a single company. Suddenly, Paris, London, Brussels, Dusseldorf are 60 milliseconds away. 60 milliseconds. Now, don't you wish you could travel like that? Be careful what you wish for.
OnNet, from MCI WorldCom.
Are obvious from the start. Like, things turn out better when you work together. That's why the UAW International Union and General Motors Corporation got together to create programs to improve skills and safety, to educate, to promote teamwork and build better quality cars and trucks. Assembly line to finish line. Teamwork wins.
You won't believe what's going down on the next Roller Jam.
Hey, Sean showed me all the moves on and off the track.
Oh, Denise, we're begging you. Give it up for the team's sake.
It's not the Denise that we know. It's not the Denise that Sundogs know.
Is she under Atkinson's evil spell?
Come on, Sundogs, get it together.
It's Quakes against Quakes and Sundogs against Sundogs. You can't miss Roller Jam. Friday at 9, 8 Central on TNN.
You're back in time for the restart. The MBNA Platinum 400 live on TNN Motorsports. They restart with 104 miles to go.
showing Dale Jarrett as the leader as they come around here.
Indeed so. He didn't pit, remember. He and Jeff Burton chose not to pit. Now, in the For What It's Worth department, just as a reminder, last year, according to my notes, and we just checked off with Dick Bergman, we had guys go 103 miles at times last year between fuel fill-ups, as you see the prior and after pit stop positions. So these guys are looking at 105, 106 miles, and the most I had last year was 103.
Yeah, that's what I had as well, so it'd be quite a stretch to see them do it. We got a long race to go. You have another caution flag and all this guessing about fuel mileage goes out the window anyway. Well, we'll see.
We're fixing to have a race for the lead right here as Rusty Wallace in the two car moves in on the back bumper of the 88 of Dale Jarrett as they go down into turn one.
Neither one of those guys pitted on that last round. They both stayed out there.
I see trouble coming. The 24, Jeff Gordon there, moved in to just an inch or two off the first two cars.
They're 99 and 12, Jeff Burton and Jeremy Mayfield. That is sixth and seventh. Those guys, along with Bobby Labonte, the eight cars on the lead lap. Now we're back up.
Oh, contact.
Rusty and Jeff.
We've seen this happen before in Richmond last year when the two of them got together. So you see Jeff Gordon using a lot of patience right now. Tony Stewart don't care. He's wide open on the outside there.
And Mark Martin's just watching. He's running fifth. We're at lap 300. 100 laps, 100 miles to go. Three wide there for a moment. David Green, the 41, Nadeau, the 9, LePage, the 16. And Trenny right there, car 43, running in 17th. Meanwhile, up front, Tony Stewart.
Jeff Gordon, Mark Martin, going through the corners there, side by side. Jeff Gordon, Tony Stewart.
This could be the rivalry of the next decade right there. Two young sprint car drivers running the high banks together. You're going to see a lot of that in the next 10 years.
You're going to see a lot of that sprint car, too, as long as Mark Martin stays in the shape he's in. He really knows how to dial a car in. You can see it moving right along.
Dale Jarrett is the race leader. Rusty Wallace is second.
Just motored by Rusty Wallace on the outside, coming out of turn four and down the front straightaway. He's on the move right now.
If you're a Brett Bodine fan, the Paychex Ford has returned to the racetrack. Quick trip to the garage. He's five laps down. Robert Presley will not return. An electrical problem in his car. He is done for the afternoon.
Hear a little backfire there. Sounds like maybe an exhaust gasket might be leaking just a little bit on Mark Martin's car. When he backs off of it, it pops just a little bit getting in the corner.
Now from this scramble forward to that number 88, the Dale Jarrett car. Jarrett's a half second up on Gordon and Rusty, 1.5 seconds on Martin and Stewart and Burton. 3.5 up on Jeremy Mayfield. And 3.6 seconds up on Bobby Labonte. Those are the only cars on the lead lap.
Look at Tony Stewart. He's making it all go. Look at the fight side by side. Mark Martin on the outside. Tony Stewart takes it.
Fourth place swapping around.
Tough young man, Tony Stewart. Said last week at Charlotte he was both tired and sick. Sick and tired. But you know where he was the very next day? In Indianapolis, helping the crew with the IndyCar.
There you see seventh spot having just swapped around. Bobby Labonte made the move around Jeremy Mayfield. So Bobby's seventh, Mayfield is eighth. Maybe the hard luck story as Earnhardt goes another lap down. Maybe the hard luck story of the day is Kenny Wallace, who's in the top five all day. Now he's with Steve Burns in the garage.
Well, Kenny, you had a super run going. How do you feel and what happened?
Well, just real disappointing. You know, we come off of turn two there. I don't know, you know, I don't really know what happened. All I know is I was in the wall.
No, I was on the outside of Jeremy. Really have to look at the replay. I was in the wall before I knew it. So it's a bummer.
No, Craig. His teammates from Andy Petrie Racing, Ken Schrader's team, are also helping repair this car. But it looks done for the day.
Tough break for Kenny Wallace. There's a good scramble. Mayfield and Skinner. They are being separated by a lap. But nevertheless, they're checking things out. There goes third place. You don't know where to look. We're going to talk about the lead, and here comes third place.
If you want excitement, just follow that orange car there, the 20 car, Tony Stewart. Man, he makes the move, and the longer he runs, he's like a Jeff Burton you see just now entering the picture there in the 99 car. The longer he runs, the better that car seems to work.
Riding with Jeff Burton in sixth.
Up from 37th spot. If this guy could only qualify well here at Dover, he'd probably win a whole pile of races. But 37th this time for this race. He was 37th qualifying for last year's race. Always seems to finish well, though.
Yes, he does. Here's the battle for the lead. Jeff Gordon.
Oh!
Close to Jarrett.
Gordon has been running out close to the wall, coming off all the corners. That time he came extremely close to the 88 Dale Jarrett. Didn't hit him, though.
So at lap 312, the lead will swap around, and Jeff Gordon takes over the top spot. But again, remember, folks, if you're just tuning in, if we do not have any more cautions, it is doubtful as to how many teams can go to the front. Hello, Jennifer.
I've won my share of races, but I didn't do it alone. It takes a great team.
The Slick 50 is a part of my team. I'm one of the millions of people who rely on it.
Now there's Slick 50 Synchron Synthetic Engine Treatment with a 100,000-mile limited warranty and pour and drive convenience.
It's hard to beat Slick 50. I count on that.
Slick 50 Synchron Synthetic, the next generation of engine treatments.
And for peak performance, use Slick 50 Synchron Synthetic Fuel System Treatment.
You got feet that sweat for a living, and you get athlete's foot. Smart guys know comfort comes in yellow. New improved Desinex powder, it gets rid of the fungus and absorbs twice as much moisture as tenactin. Desinex soothes while it cures for comfortable feet.
Today we're going to learn the easy way to mow the lawn. This is a lawn. This is a boy. Lawn. Boy. Lawn. Boy. Lawn boy. Easy, huh?
Lawn boy. Easy to start, easy to use, easy to maintain.
Any questions?
Why are there two of you?
Need brakes? Now during the Midas $40 lifetime brakes rebate, save $20 per axle or $40 for your whole car. Lifetime guarantee $40 in savings right now. Go safely. Go Midas.
Edgar and I have so much in common. It's like we were long-lost brothers.
We both have larger-than-average ears.
We both have pretty straight hair.
It's creepy.
And get this. We both love the taste of Miller Lite because of the choice hops. It's like we were separated at birth.
Actually, George, I think Miller Lite tastes great because it's smooth.
Excuse me?
I like the smoothness.
Who are you?
Miller Lite, the great taste of a true Pilsner beer.
TNN Motorsports live coverage of the MBNA Platinum 400 is being brought to you by Lawn Boy, making mowing easier. By Midas, go safely, go Midas. And by Miller Genuine Draft, proud sponsor of the Miller Racing Team, we race for beer. There's Jeff Gordon. He is the race leader by 6/10 of a second over Dale Jarrett and Tony Stewart. Remember a year ago? We've seen this storyline before. Jeff Gordon dominated. But late in the race, as might happen today, he had to stop a splash of fuel, lap 393, and Dale Jarrett went on to what was, in some instances, an unexpected victory. And there you see Gordon back to Jarrett again, 7/10 of a second. And there's a question once more about who can go the distance. Glenn Jarrett, at your end of pit road, how many guys are going to roll the dice? How many are going to have to stop? What are they saying?
Well, Eli, the 18 car says that he can, obviously, because he pitted at the very end of that caution period. But the 99, the 6, the 88, the 12, and the 2, everybody else says that they cannot make it.
Well, we'll find out if indeed they are telling us the truth. The other guy in that mix, Ralph, is the fellow you've been following today, Tony Stewart. Can they go?
No, Eli, they cannot. They're getting the worst gas mileage they've gotten all reason of season. One of the reasons being that Tony's been very hard on the throttle today. He's been racing so hard, he's been burning up a lot of fuel. They know they're going to need to come in and take on a little bit more.
Meanwhile, Bobby Labonte has just slid by the number two of Rusty Wallace to grab the fifth spot. You'll see all those numbers in the upper left of the screen. Timing and scoring provided by MCI OnNet. From MCI WorldCom, your one connection to the world. Now you take a look at the guys who are running up front right now. Four of the first six have won races here before. Nine wins in total. So, there's some experience near the front of the field.
Eli, do you want to see where Tony Stewart's strong? Look, watch him up out of the corner. Yeah, this car is a bullet coming up out of the corner. You see on the outside, he and Dale Jarrett, they go down in straightaways about the same. They hit the corners. Now watch him when he picks the throttle up. He just motors right on out of sight.
The Pontiacs have been doing that all day today. He and Bobby Labonte both.
Well, yeah, but let's also remember that last week after the race at Charlotte, NASCAR impounded several of the cars, put them on the dyno jet. They don't release the horsepower numbers. But we did some snooping around the garage, and people tell us that that 20 car had more power than anybody else. Greg Zipidelli, the crew chief, however, says, well, it's no big deal because we cooled our engine off, and a cool engine's going to make more power. Let me tell you, that picture proves it. They've got plenty of motor in that automobile, as does the 88, as does the 6. Three very strong cars today.
Stewart's now in second. You saw him move by Jarrett, and now Jarrett just can't use the low side of the racetrack. And he's going to lose a spot to Mark Martin as well.
You know, one thing you do a lot of, I remember when I used to run, you would get with the engine guy on Monday morning and say, I was a little bit off in the center part of the corner. We need to work on the torque curve on this motor. And next time you come up, you'd have a combination like that. Well, Bobby Labonte's already done that for the 20 car. They just go with, hey, stuff he's done 2 years, 3 years back.
We're at lap 326 of 200. There you see the relationship from Jarrett ahead to Martin, ahead to Stewart, and then 1 1/10 seconds further forward to that man, Jeff Gordon, who just went around Kenny Schrader. If you're tuning in, Schrader had an accident back on lap 6 and spent 263 laps in the garage fixing it. But Kenny is out there doing whatever he can. Burns is down in the Jeff Gordon pit.
Eli just spoke to Ray Evernham and asked if they could make it to the end on gas, and he handed me a note that said we're going to have to stop about 5 laps from the finish. The other thing to consider right now is he's starting to get loose on the racetrack, and they've been chasing it all day long between loose and tight. But again, 5 laps short of making it on gas.
Interesting to see what happened. Remember, Bobby Labonte could be the wild card in all of this because he came in, topped off at lap 293. Now look at that. Quickest lap right now, Gordon. Dale Earnhardt, unfortunately, not on the lead lap, but he's turning in some impressive speed numbers.
Very good lap. But one thing that dictates the speed around a racetrack is how much lap traffic you have to put away on that particular lap where those things come up. So that's not, you have to do that 3 or 4 laps before you really know who's really quick out there.
And the traffic really hasn't thinned out much today because only Dick Trickle, Michael Waltrip, Robert Presley, and Kenny Wallace are in the garage. Everybody else still out there on the racetrack. At lap 331, 400 makes up the distance here at Dover.
In our quest for the finest brakes in the world, we tested our pads against other leading brands. With pad after pad, in test after test, the results were always the same. No other brand stopped shorter. than Performance Friction Carbon Metallic. The ones we stock at AutoZone.
This Father's Day, imagine how thrilled Dad will be to wake up to Mach 3. New from Gillette. Give him the best. The first triple blade razor for a shave he'll never forget. Mach 3 from Gillette.
We've heard your complaints about changing your oil filter, trying to grip that slippery filter. That's why Fram, America's number one filter, now has Sure Grip, a rough textured top for easy gripping and installing.
It makes changing your oil filter a lot easier.
The Rumble at Route 66, Saturday on TNN.
Every driver on the road needs one place they can rely on. On weekends, I've got my pit crew. But during the week, I pull into Parts Plus. They have all the auto parts I need and real professionals who can solve problems. I guess that's why they're not just parts. They're Parts Plus.
Available in Springfield at Thomas Auto Supply and Parts Plus downtown.
You want to have some fun this summer? Then come to Westtown in Jacksonville, because Jeeps are fun.
All of us like the feeling that comes with peeling down the soft top and cruising down the highway with the sun in our faces and the wind in our hair. And Westtown has a great selection of Jeep Wranglers, Cherokees, and Grand Cherokees.
So have some fun this summer with your Jeep from Westtown Lincoln Mercury Jeep in Jacksonville. Tell them Pete said.
Welcome back to Dover. Don't forget, folks, following the race today at around 4:30 Eastern time, give or take a bit, it's bench racing at its best. Some of the greatest racing stories you may have never heard before. It is the Stock Car Legends Reunion right here on TNN Motorsports, coming up right after our coverage of the MBNA Platinum 400. We're riding with Wally Dallenbach. He's three laps down in 21st position in the Budweiser Chevy, and his corporate teammate Jeff Gordon about to put him another lap down, which he does. Fellas already out of the event. Dick Trickle with the accident earlier today. Michael Waltrip with engine failure. We talked about the electrical problem for Robert Presley. Kenny Wallace still in the garage area after his accident. I don't know if they'll be able to rebuild that race car in the half hour or so that remain of competition here today. There you see the 20 car, Tony Stewart, 1 3/10 seconds behind Jeff Gordon. See, Gordon is three cars further forward.
You know, listen how far he goes through the corner before he picks the throttle up again.
And he's so smooth.
Yeah, but he was three quarters of the way through the corner early in the race. They were inside the car. They were getting back in the throttle before they got to halfway of the corner.
Well, let's listen to Mark Martin as he comes out of four and goes to turn one. Let's see what his style sounds like.
Well, he rides with his left foot on the brake, not putting it on the brake itself, but right on the brake there. When he gets back in the throttle, you can hear it right there, just kind of ease back in the throttle.
Were the acceleration points and braking points basically the same on asphalt?
Not really, because an asphalt base has a lot of give to it. You've been on the road on a hot day, and you can actually feel a softer surface where the concrete here is like a... Well, it's like what it is. It's concrete. Yeah. It don't give any at all.
Now, there's Bobby Labonte. He's running in fifth place. Let's see what his approach to the turns are like.
The eight-cylinder symphony. Here it is.
You can hardly hear it when he picks it back up. Boy, I tell you what, that's an engine man's dream when you get a guy that gets back in the throttle like that instead of just romping down on it.
Well, he and his brother are incredibly smooth race car drivers. Nothing rough about
their style at all.
Let's go down to Glenn Jarrett.
Yeah, Eli, that's precisely what Jimmy Makar just told Bobby. Jimmy, of course, the crew chief on the car, told him that they should be okay on fuel, but to be very, very careful with the throttle. And obviously, as we just saw, Bobby Labonte is doing just that. They really think that they can make it so far down here, other than them, and other than the 88 and the 99. I'm not sure that they're not the only ones down here telling me the truth. I don't know, man.
Well, he came in to top off at lap 293. But then ran a couple more laps under caution before we went to green. So he's still looking at 104, 105 miles.
I've always been leery of talking to crew chiefs because I know how they act. It's like going to Vegas and saying, is this a good table?
Yeah, they don't keep the lights burning from all the winners.
You bet.
Well, if Bobby Labonte does win this race today, he surely deserves it. In the first six races this year, he's got a couple of seconds, four thirds. That's half the races. He's been second or third. He's led them all but one. He's got more poles than anybody. Overdue to win. He surely is.
You realize, too, that Bobby has finished fourth here in the last three Dover races and four of the last five times he has finished fourth. Strange how you just kind of reach that level, but he is a man very much in position to try and grab a win, especially if everybody else has to stop. Everybody waiting and watching. Joe Gibbs says we might be able to pull it out. Who knows?
You know, my first racing days were pretty rough. With my wheels set so close together, I was always getting loose in the turns. Now that I'm trading paint with the big boys, wider is better.
With speed-sensitive steering, the White Track Grand Prix delivers precise control in the corners. No wonder it's been selected official pace car of NASCAR.
There's no getting around it. Wider is
the White Track Grand Prix. Wider is better. By Pontiac.
TNN salutes a century of motorsports and the advent of on-the-air racing.
We'll also talk to Richard Childress's team and try to figure out what makes them click and has made them the number one team in Winston Cup racing for the last 2 years.
Big Bill Franz, the visionary leader of NASCAR, formed the Motor Racing Network in 1970 to broadcast NASCAR races on the radio. Today, over 450 stations coast to coast carry the MRN broadcasts. By 1979, longtime MRN veteran Ken Squire had convinced CBS Sports to broadcast the Daytona 500 live, flag to flag. It was a first on TV. Of course, nowadays, all Winston Cup, Busch, and Craftsman Truck Series races are on both radio and television. And you can check out any number of internet sites full of racing data, stories, and pictures. We suggest country.com as your first and best stop for all things racing and for all things country.
Brought to you by Haviland Formula 3 Motor Oil. Add more life to your car.
Good morning, Mr. Clark.
Morning, Tommy.
Good morning, Mr. Clark.
Morning, Tommy.
Good morning, Mr. Clark.
Morning, Tommy.
Amazing. That car never ages.
To help keep your car young, protect your engine with Haviland Formula 3 Motor Oil. Add more life to your car.
Welcome back to Dover, where the action began. Lap number 6, Kenny Schrader had a problem in the wall. Chad Little spun at lap 278. And then Kenny Wallace bounced off the wall, off Jeremy Mayfield, and off the wall again at lap 289. As we welcome you back live now, Jeff Gordon showing the way here at the Monster Mile. The only other caution we didn't show you is when Dave Marcus had a problem with oil on the racetrack. All right, who's where? There is Jeff Gordon, the race leader. There is second place, 1 3/10 seconds back, Tony Stewart. Next in line at this stage of the day is Kyle Petty. He's in 32nd spot, 8 laps down to the race leader. Kenny Schrader's out there in 42nd spot. Kenny is 265 laps down. You see Brett Bodine going through the picture. He is now being shown a dozen laps down in 37th position. Mark Martin is next. He's 3.8 seconds behind Jeff Gordon, running in third on the lead lap. Mike Skinner coming into your picture right there. He is now in 12th place. He's being shown three laps down behind Gordon. Ted Musgrave is in 24th. There he is. Musgrave being shown four laps down in 24th position. Then you got a good scramble there. Dale Jarrett in fourth. Bobby Labonte in fifth. Those two battling for position on the lead lap, 4.5 seconds back. And then you've got the 40 right there, Sterling Marlin in 30th. He is seven laps back. The 58 is Ricky Craven. He is eight laps back in 33rd position. And the 16 is Kevin LePage, who was running near the front early today, but he's now in 25th, four laps down. That's LePage in the 16. Now you've got Ernie Irvin in the 36 car. He's running in 34th position. Rich Bickle is passing him. That is for position. Each one of those fellows six laps down. They are swapping 34th and 35th spot between them. Then you've got Wally Dallenbach in 21st position. He is being shown three laps down now. And the three of Dale Earnhardt, he is a lap down in ninth. Only eight cars are on the lead lap. One of them is Rusty Wallace in the two. Rusty is now in sixth position, and he's going to be shown 12 seconds back of the race leader. Then you've got the nine of Jerry Nadeau, the WCW car. He is four laps down in 27. Now Elliott Sadler, the Wood Brothers Citgo machine. He, too, is four laps down in 28th. And Bill Elliott right there along with him. And Bill Elliott was running in the 13th spot, as we see how Elliott Sadler does in the Wood Brothers entry. 8,300 RPM before he woes it down to the corner. Continuing our drop back through the field now behind Elliott Sadler. Here comes Jeremy Mayfield in the 12. He is in seventh place, and Jeremy is being shown on the lead lap 17 seconds back. Then Jeff Burton, he is 17.8 seconds back, also on the lead lap in eighth. Like eight cars on the lead lap, that is all. Then behind him, you've got the John Andretti car. There is the STP Pontiac. Jimmy Spencer out there as well. Spencer in 21st. Andretti was running 14th. Chad Little in the 97 John Deere machine. He had that spin earlier. He's in 30th now, being shown six laps down. Rick Mast just being bypassed by Bobby Hamilton. Hamilton in that orange number four. He's in 22nd, three laps down. And Rick Mast finds himself in 31st now, and he is six laps down. Further back, you've got Dave Marcus. He's been on and off pit road much of the day. Dave is 61 laps back in the 71. That yellow and black number one is Steve Park. Park's in 15th, three laps down. And Kenny Irwin, he is in 10th, two laps down. Johnny Benson, who led briefly today in the 26, is 11th. He's two laps behind Jeff Gordon, the race leader. Ricky Rudd is still out there running in 23rd spot. That's he in the 10 car. He is four laps down and about to potentially be lapped again by our race leader, Jeff Gordon, there in the DuPont Chevrolet. So that's who's on the racetrack running. In the garage are Dick Trickle, Michael Waltrip, Robert Presley, and Kenny Wallace. And there is Stewart, having closed in within 6/10 of a second.
Exactly right. You're riding with him and just in front of us. There is Jeff Gordon coming off down the front straightaway, heading down towards turn one. Nicely done, Eli. Falling back through the field. There's people back home that want to know where these cars are running. That's the one thing I get more write-ins on. Tell us where our favorite driver is.
So everybody's got fans. Every driver has fans out there. That's what you've got to try and remember. All right, now we're getting down to nitty-gritty here. We're 34 laps from the finish. Is Tony Stewart slowing? He is. Tony Stewart is going to come in right now. So too is Johnny Benson, lap 367. Ernie Irvin is coming in. Ralph?
Eli, Tony Stewart, ask the crew if he can come in now. Get this taken care of. They're going to take on four tires and fuel. They will be scuff tires going on the car. Remember, the car has gotten a little bit tighter on this last run, and it has been all day long. They haven't made hardly any adjustments.
Tony Stewart.
Boy, you could have broken me out, and I just didn't think he would ever even think about taking on four. But, you know, they know more than I do, so they took on four tires. I was thinking maybe just a splash of fuel, maybe even not even taking on tires.
Well, it certainly is a surprise that they would come in at this point and not wait and see if there might be a caution flag to do that same activity.
How long can you wait, though? You're only 30 laps from the finish now. Ted Musgrave is in. David Green is in. Ernie Irvin has been in.
Well, that's one of the things that makes this all so interesting. NASCAR's got the cars so even now that really there's an awful lot of strategy that plays into this. And until a checkered flag falls, you just can't predict which of these strategies is going to be the right one.
You're exactly right. I never second-guessed the smartest people in the world, and that's the crew chief down there. They know what Tony Stewart needed a whole lot more than we do up here.
I would bet, and I have to look it up, but I'd bet more races have been fuel mileage races at Golden than at many, if not most, other racetracks.
Yeah,
it always seems to happen here.
Even when it was 500, they always come down to that, and then the 400 is always, it's the guy that really makes the right decision all day long.
30 laps from the finish, we return to wrap up the MBNA Platinum 400 right after these messages.
Day 19, traveling the circuits of NASCAR.
Darlington, Daytona, Talladega, Charlotte. The drivers, the cars, the action. Bumper to bumper, mano-a-mano at speeds of over 200 miles an hour, with us covering every heart-pounding, adrenaline-pumping moment at the incredible speeds of over
35 miles an hour, as fast as it goes.
What?
It's a good thing they keep going around in circles.
Introducing Bosch Platinum Plus 4. Four electrodes. Pure platinum. Take your engine to a higher power. New Bosch Platinum Plus 4.
Some of America's most successful people get their start. Did somebody say McDonald's?
Drivers, race teams, and race fans, the 99 Gene Simpson Racing Catalog is now available. For more information, call 1-800-71-RACING or visit the Simpson website at SimpsonRaceProducts.com and join Gene Simpson today. Mack Trucks are furnished by Clement Chevy Mack Sales. For all your truck and tractor needs, call Clement at 1-800-369-MACK. Winnebago Industries, the official motorhome of TNN Motorsports. For information on Winnebago Industries products for the Winnebago Motorsports team, call 1-800-643-4892.
We are back with 25 laps, 25 miles remaining. Jeff Gordon has not yet stopped while you were gone. Terry Labonte and Bill Elliott did. Mike Skinner is coming in now at lap 376. One thing about Tony Stewart, when he made his pit stop, he's now going around this racetrack with us on board at 148 miles an hour. The other guys, like a Rusty Wallace and the others who haven't stopped, are doing 144 miles an hour.
Yeah, you can see right there, he just motors away from Rusty Wallace, as does Kevin LePage. But the biggest thing that I am noticing, Mark Martin in second place right now, is catching Jeff Gordon pretty quickly.
Here comes Dale Jarrett now. He'll be coming in at lap 378. Mike Skinner will be coming back in for a stop-and-go penalty. He was too quick, exceeded the speed limit, leaving pit road. Glenn Jarrett.
Yes, he did, and Dale Jarrett comes down now. This should be fuel only, if I knew exactly what they were talking about on the radio. And the crew goes out, cleans the windshield. One, two, three, four, five, about 5.5, 6 seconds of gas. 4.5 second stoppage. I think they got in about 4.5 or 5 gallons of gas on DJ.
Ralph Shaheen, any second thoughts of the Tony Stewart pit?
Let's find out from crew chief Greg Zipadelli, who's taking a quick look at the screen. Why did you pit then, and why did you take more time?
We just decided to short stop. It was probably our only shot. We seem to be really good. We make a lot of time up on new tires. Everybody else has to stop except for the 18. And it's just a gamble for us. It's the only thing I think we had the choice to do.
Well, sometimes it's got to take your chance as best you can. There you see Gordon. The lead he has back to Mark Martin is only 1 3/10 seconds. So that deal's not settled yet.
Not at all. Mark Martin is just able to drive that race car anywhere he wants to. Gordon right now looks to be very defensive on the racetrack as far as the line he's keeping. Jeff Burton's heading into the pit road right as we speak.
As is Jeremy Mayfield. Both those cars pitting right now.
So Burton, who did not pit at lap 290, pits here at 382.
No tires, a splash of fuel, and a round in or out of the right rear, pardon me.
You see Jeremy Mayfield there, same scenario, splash of fuel. Sterling Marlin comes in at lap 383. Bobby Hamilton. Steve Park. 17 miles from the finish.
Steve Park taking on two tires, it looks like.
Yeah, nearly nailing his front tire changer as he went flying across in front of that car.
Those guys are athletes. They can jump that whole car if they need to.
Yeah, well, they kind of had to.
I remember Bill Elliott there, 94 has been in. Skinner's been in. That's why they're moving by our race leader, Gordon. There comes Mark Martin.
You can see he's only about 5 car lengths back. Mark Martin has made up a lot of time on the 24 of Jeff Gordon. Down into turn one, Mark Martin right on the bottom of the racetrack there.
Folks, I wish you could see Buddy Baker as he talks about that, because he leans to the left as he's describing how they go through the first corner. You haven't quit driving, you're just driving the television booth, that's all.
I love it up here. I tell you what, it's nice to get paid for having fun.
Rusty Wallace is going to make a pit stop at lap 386. If you're just joining us, let me just turn the race on for the first time. We are nearing the finish. At this point, just 15 miles to go. Most everyone needs to make a pit stop, except potentially Bobby Labonte. At the other end of pit road, Dale Earnhardt is in for his stop. Here comes Mark Martin. Mark Martin is in. Lap 387 is when the Valvoline team will come in. And that pit road speed, though it's the same for everybody, Glenn, it's got to be painfully slow for a driver.
Oh, you know, I watched Dale Earnhardt just come by me. He just made his stop. And Mark Martin, it just looks like they're creeping along to us. Now Mark finally gets to the pit stall. This will be fuel only. I figure about 3.5-4 seconds of fuel. And Mark is running away. That's about what it was. They may have got about 3.5-4 gallons in there. That's all we needed to get to the end.
So we have not seen a pit stop for that man. We have not seen a pit stop for Bobby Labonte either. Indication is that Bobby can go the distance. He pitted at lap 293, came in and topped it off. After pitting at lap 290, and then when he came in at 293, still ran a few laps under caution.
Eli, listen on the throttle here. He's barely getting back in the throttle. He's waiting all the way to the straightaway now before he gets back wide open on it. He's going to try to make it.
10 laps to go. Ray Evernham says, I hope we can make it. Bobby Labonte, should he inherit the lead, hasn't led since lap 207.
I guarantee you a piece of trash run through that line and through the carburetor on that 24, and Jeff Gordon would jump out the window almost. It scared him so bad.
Now there's a look back from the leader, still waiting for Bobby Labonte. There he is. It is 5 4/10 seconds. So conventional wisdom says if Gordon doesn't have to stop, Bobby's not going to make up 5.5 seconds in 9 miles of racing. But remember last year.
Oh, yeah.
Gordon had to stop. Gave Dale Jarrett an unexpected victory with 7 miles to go.
Gino supposed Ray's going to leave him out there this whole time. What do you think?
For the people that want to know where Tony Stewart's at, he's running in fourth place right now.
That'll be 110 miles from the pit stop at lap 290. And granted, a number of laps were run under caution.
Yep. Well, they know that car. They know that engine.
Glenn, what are you hearing?
Well, Eli, they have talked about fuel, but now they're suddenly really silent. They're still talking about it, but they still think that they can go. They've got a can of fuel sitting out here ready, but I don't think that they're going to have to pit. This car has traditionally gotten
here
some of the best mileage. Gordon on the pit right now.
Here comes Jeff Gordon, lap 394. He and Andretti will pit. The leader will be Batman, Bobby Labonte. Let's cover the Gordon pit stop.
And Jeff Gordon comes in quickly. This is going to be a gas only, a splash of gas. No tires. Jeff Gordon is gone.
We have seen this script before 1 year ago.
Talk about a splash. Now, that was a splash. That was less than 2 seconds of fuel he took on there.
But he's only got to go 6 miles.
Right.
Exactly right.
Well, is Bobby Labonte going to make it? Is he going to run out of gas, or is he going to win the race?
Yes, they could go, said crew chief Jimmy Maycar. If not, now that'll be a whole other story. Everything will cycle back around now to Gordon. And there you see Labonte.
And back behind there, Mark Martin made a pit stop, did not take on tires. Tony Stewart is moving in on him as we speak. There's the sixth car, and just behind these two cars, Tony Stewart's making his way up.
Stewart's in fourth spot. Martin is in third. Stewart took on four tires when he pitted.
Fresher tires mean faster laps, so he may catch him before it's over.
There's Stewart.
You see the difference. About 15 car lengths. A boy on fresh tires like that, he'll close that gap pretty quickly on Mark Martin.
It'll be the white flag next time by for Bobby Labonte. That little visit to pit road at lap 293 might be the difference between the garage and victory lane.
That and being so precise with the throttle. Tony Stewart is not going to catch the six car. It does not look like it.
White flag for Bobby Labonte. Started on the Bud Pole. He has never won here at the Monster Mile.
He can almost toast his miss as he goes into turn three.
And
I guarantee you, easy on the throttle.
I guess. This will be the 37th race since last he won. Bobby Labonte wins here at Boomer Downs International Speedway. Yes, sir. That pole pays off. And Bobby Labonte makes it to the finish, Glenn Jarrett.
Yes, he did. We got Jimmy Maycar up here. He's getting congratulations from the crew. Jimmy, come down here a minute, buddy. What a great call on lap 293 or 293 it was to make that thing 107 laps.
Well, you know, it was one of them deals. We really didn't have much choice there. We weren't that far toward the front. We couldn't race with those guys. The 24 and the 20 were a little bit better than us, and we knew that. And we got inside our fuel window. We thought, well, what the heck? We're going to lose two spots on the racetrack. We got a lot of green flag racing today. Who knows? You know, we might get lucky here and go green the rest of the way. And good Lord had it that way. I mean, it was pure luck there.
Okay, congratulations to those guys. We're going to all head to victory lane.
You do that, and we will be heading right there with you as the other Joe Gibbs crew from Tony Stewart's team congratulate Bobby Labonte.
Good morning, Mr. Clark.
Morning, Tommy.
Good morning, Mr. Clark.
Morning, Tommy.
Good morning, Mr. Clark.
Morning, Tommy.
Amazing. That car never ages.
To help keep your car young, protect your engine with Havoline Formula 3 motor oil. Add more life to your car.
For centuries, our kings were cursed.
Their sedans had narrow handrails, making them hard to control in the corners. Sadly, many kings lost their thrones. Eventually, it was learned, wider is better.
With its speed-sensitive steering technology, the Wide Track Grand Prix gives you precise control in the corners.
Ancient scriptures still read, your young bull, Gakito.
Wider is better. The Wide Track Grand Prix by Pontiac.
There's a moment as I bite into a Wendy's classic double with cheese when everything around me seems to come to a stop. My senses focus on that hot, juicy beef and cool, crisp toppings. For that frozen moment, all seems right in the world. Of course, nothing lasts forever. Then again, I can always come back tomorrow.
Wow, this is nutty.
Hamburger bliss. It comes with every Wendy's classic hamburger.
There's a lot of reasons why so many people who take care of their cars turn to AutoZone each week. The low prices on the replacement parts they really need, and the large selection of the things they simply want. But most of all, they come to AutoZone because of the helpful, friendly people who work there. The kind of folks who know their stuff and who'll go the extra mile to help you out. Because after all, taking pride in taking care of people is what AutoZone is all about.
TNN Motorsports live coverage of the MBNA Platinum 400 has been brought to you by Haviland Formula 3 Motor Oil. Add more life to your car. And by the Wide Track Grand Prix by Pontiac. Wider is better. There is our race winner and our Bud Pole sitter earlier today. It wasn't really flag to flag, but it turns out that way. In the box score, Bobby Labonte wins here at Dover. Let's go to victory lane.
And Eli was certainly the most important flag for Bobby Labonte. Now, I know that Jimmy Makar told you guys could go 107 laps on fuel, but did you believe him?
Well, yeah, I have to. You know, that's my job. And I tell you, Patty Makar at home, she probably was doubting that little call right there, but it's just an inside joke. But I tell you what, you know, we had about a fourth-place car. I got to Dale Jarrett, and I just kind of hung out there. I said, well, I think we can make it on gas, and those guys can't. So hopefully that'll be the case. And I mean, it just came down to fuel mileage, and that's all it was about. And we weren't quite as good as the 24, the 20, and the 6. Could run with the 88, but just kind of handled there, hung there for a while. But, you know, this Interstate Pontiac ran great. That's the best I think I've ever run here. The pace just picked up a little bit, so I was tickled to death over that. These guys did a great job. MBNA, the folks there, sponsor the race. They also sponsor this race car, so that's awfully good for them. Coca-Cola, Husqvarna, Easy Care, heck, I don't know, Cintas, Circuit City. What else we got?
Ditch Witch, Easy Care, Husqvarna. You want me to help you out?
Tools, I got a lot of them. So anyway, most important thing is Joe Gibbs, these guys. Tony run a great race today, and we're only a week late and $1 million short, but that's okay.
Well, now, we were watching you, though, there. You were consciously conserving fuel. You were not pushing the race car at all that last 100 miles, though.
I did for the first little bit because I wanted to get myself in a position where, you know, I didn't want to lose too much. But once, with about 50 to go, I started, you're right, I did start to lay back a little bit in there. And I really laid back with about 10 to go because the fuel pressure was dropping down to 3 pounds down at the end of the straightaway. So it was awful close.
Well, Bobby Labonte has run awfully well several times this year and came up second. Today, he didn't run quite as well as some guys, but he beat them to victory lane. Congratulations to those guys.
And we had talked in the pre-race show about whether starting on the pole was mathematically the place to be. Well, today it pays off as the 10th Dover race ever of the 59 that have been competed here. Only the 10th time it's been won by the pole sitter. We'll go to the garage to chat with more drivers in a moment.
I travel light. I can pack everything I need into a weekend. Ranger, built Ford tough.
This summer, if you can dream it up, Sonic can put it in a cup. We've got hundreds of drink flavors you can mix and match. Plus, our 44-ounce Route 44 big drinks. Enough choices to let your dreams run wild. Sonic America's driving.
Were you born without a soul?
It's just an oil filter.
Nothing stops more dirt than America's number one brand of oil filter, Fran.
Adam, get out of here.
Fram oil filters. Pay a little more now or pay a lot later.
Hey, look, the oil came right out.
The Pocono 500, June 20th at 1 Eastern on TNN.
Hi, I'm Bob Ridings. At Bob Ridings in Taylorville, we have a great selection of the new redesigned lineup from Chrysler, Plymouth, and Jeep, the Chrysler 300M Series, and the sleek new look of the Chrysler LHS and Chrysler Concord. See these impressive cars and the all-new redesigned Jeep Grand Cherokee at Bob Ridings Chrysler, Plymouth, and Jeep in Taylorville. Remember, we're still just 30 minutes away from high prices.
Say goodbye to that favorite shirt? Not if you've got DD7. DD7 is a super concentrated formula that removes stains but won't harm fabric. Dye from a red sock, ink, iodine, a little DD7, and goodbye to unwanted stains. Restore curtains to like new whiteness. DD7 is a whiz on carpet, even upholstery. Think of the money you'll save. It's goodbye to those unwanted stains forever. DD7 is available at fine retailers everywhere.
A crowd of 122,000 now filing out of Dover Downs. Quick reminder again, folks, that TNN Motorsports is offering to you official NASCAR collectibles, including that die-cast replica of the Dale Earnhardt flashback Wrangler Monte Carlo that he drove at the Winston a few weeks ago. To order any of the great NASCAR products you're interested in, call TNN Motorsports toll-free at 1-877-TNN-1999. TNN Motorsports, your NASCAR connection. Only two cars finished on the lead lap because of that cycling of pit stops down the stretch. One, obviously, is Bobby Labonte, and the other is Jeff Gordon. There he is.
Well, Jeff, how close was it? You got to within a handful of laps. Did it burp on you at the end?
Well, no, it never did. I was having a lot of trouble hearing on the radio what Ray was saying. I couldn't tell if he was saying let off and stretch it or, go for it, and we are going to hope for a caution. I think that's what the strategy was. We knew we were going to get beat, and it's like hope for a caution so we can win the race. If a caution didn't come out, then, we were going to have to come in. We did the right thing. Ray, he's smart with that stuff. And, when I'm in the car, it's frustrating not to know exactly what's going to happen. But when he took that splash of gas, that's basically what got us second place. So, we came into this race saying, hey, we need a good finish, and we got that today. And, we didn't win, but we had a car capable of winning, and this is what we need to get back on track.
Now, you've won races on fuel economy, like at Las Vegas, and you've lost races, like twice here at Dover, on fuel economy. Is there an art to fuel economy, or is it a black science?
Well, the art is to have fuel mileage, by how well the carburetor conserves fuel. But I was letting off, quite a bit there at the end. It'd be interesting to see how much fuel is left in the thing. You never really get a chance to stretch it all the way, but they check fuel mileage throughout the race, and that's how they evaluate that at the end. And I know they made the right call, and we did everything we could, tuning that carburetor, tuning that engine, to make sure that we didn't get beat on fuel mileage, but we did. Bobby came in, took that splash of gas there, and you can do that when you're a few places back. When we're one of the leaders, it's tough to do that.
Steve Burns.
I thank Raffle with Tony Stewart. Tony, a great run. You guys were a factor to win this race today. How do you feel?
I feel great. It was great for all the guys in this Home Depot team, and it's great to see one of our cars get in victory lane finally this season. I can't say enough about Greg Zipadelli and my guys. Like normal, I'm like a broken record because these guys just keep giving me great race cars each week, and I'm just the one guy that gets all the glory for driving them around in circles all day. So, we had a great day. Led a lot of laps, and ran with some more of the guys up front that we got to run with each week. So, hopefully we can keep the streak going.
Tony, there was a lot of attention on you last weekend in Charlotte, obviously running both races at Indy and then back in Charlotte. Was it more business as usual for you this weekend? Was it easier to focus or concentrate?
I think we're still catching up a little bit from last weekend. I never would have dreamed it would have taken as much out of me as it did. And, Monday was bad, Tuesday was worse, and then it started getting better. But I still, I kept telling people I felt 100% this week. I haven't felt 100% since 2 weeks ago. So, it was great to come here, and this place is so tough to run 400 miles here for the first time and come out with the way we finished. It's just a great day for all of us.
And Greg told me before the race, you don't have any time off. You go right to Pocono to test there.
Yeah, I'll try to get as much sleep as I can tonight because he's going to wear me out the next 2 days at Pocono. But, you know, that's what's got us here, is going and doing a lot of testing and, you know, the preparation each week. So we're going to stick to our schedule.
All right, congratulations. Let's go to Glenn Jarrett.
Hey, thanks, Steve. We're still in victory lane down here, standing by with the car owner of the winning car and the fourth-place car, the driver just talked to, Tony Stewart, Joe Gibson. Wow, what a great day for you.
Absolutely thrilled for Home Depot. Tony Stewart ran up front all day. We're really thrilled with them. And I tell you, Bobby, the Lord's blessed us with great race teams and great drivers, and this is truly a team effort. Everybody at Interstate Batteries want to say congratulations to everybody back there. Bobby was great. Jimmy made a great call. Pit stops are great. Like I said, it was just it was one of those great days. You don't experience this very often, so we're going to be thrilled and enjoy this. I thought we were going to run away and leave a couple of races and win some races, run away from them. This one was a gas mileage deal, but yet we were thrilled. We had a strong car too, so I'm really pleased for everybody and really happy for obviously for Interstate Batteries.
Well, like anybody else, he'll take them anyway he can get them.
Amen to that. The victories are very precious commodities in this world, and they pulled off a big win today. We're coming right back. More guys to chat with as we return to Dover in a moment.
Whenever you see racetracks around the world, you usually see Mobil 1 signs. So many people think that Mobil 1 synthetic is only for high-performance cars. Well, let me dispel that myth for you right now. Mobil 1 can improve the performance of almost any car while protecting the engine even under the most severe conditions. So for the same reason the race guys use Mobil 1, so should you.
Nothing outperforms Mobil 1.
Out of luck with a flat tire? Not with this tire. Even with no air pressure, you drive to safety. Goodyear Aqua Steel Run Flat. Find the safe way home.
Goodyear, Goodyear.
You know what I call this?
Dancing.
No, it's the collect call with 1-800-CALLATT. Just dial right down the center of the phone. CALLATT. For guaranteed cheap collect calls, dial 1-800-CALL-ATT.
Don't forget, coming up in a couple of weeks, the same stars and cars you saw here this afternoon. We'll be right back on TNN Motorsports on Sunday, June 20th, 1 o'clock Eastern, 10 Pacific, the Pocono 500 from that triangular Pocono International Raceway. It brings about a different set of concerns versus what we had to deal with here today. That's coming up in 2 weeks, where compromise in your car setup is more the byword than anything else. That's coming up from Pocono here on TNN Motorsports in just a couple of weeks' time. Now, take a look at that. Johnny Benson in seventh. Kenny Irwin finishing in 10th. And for Kenny, that's going to be his best finish since that third-place run at Daytona back in Speed Weeks.
Good strong run for him. Earnhardt from the back of the pack to 11th. Bill Elliott had a good day today, finishing in 12th spot.
Yeah, Earnhardt went down the lap there in the very early stages of the race. The rest of the way, he was almost as good as the leaders.
Elliott Sadler in 27th spot. Jerry Nadeau around in 30th. Then you get some of the fellows who had problems throughout the course of the day.
Boy, that 39th spot sticks out. Kenny Wallace running in the top five all day long, had a great run, and then got in the wall on the back straightaway, bounced over into the 12th car of Jeremy Mayfield.
You curious about Schrader? By coming out and running a few more laps, he got ahead of Michael Waltrip. He would have finished in 42nd, picks up three more points to finish in 41st. Johnny Benson, though, as we said, had a super run today. Steve, I believe, has caught up with him in the garage.
Yes, we have, Eli. Johnny's just out of the back of the truck talking to the team. I bet that was a pretty good conversation up there.
Been a lot better than it has been lately. There's no doubt about it. But Pat Tryson made a good call. The guys did a tremendous job tuning the engine, getting a fuel mileage that we needed. And I'm telling you what, the guys just done good all day. The car was terrible at the beginning. Pat and the guys got it good, and we just hung on. We hung on, and like I said, got to definitely thank Cheerios for sticking with us through the hard times here. Hopefully the good times will keep coming. We need to build on this, there's no doubt.
Johnny, a lot of guys don't believe in moral victories, but as you said, this could be a momentum builder.
Oh, there's no doubt. You know, everybody's still real supportive, there's no doubt, but everybody just hates running bad, you know. So, I don't know. Like I said, we're happy with that. We need to build on this and keep going. I mean, we need to get in the top 15 in points, and that's stretching it. You know, we wanted the top 10 to start with, and we haven't been able to do that. So, you know, we're working real hard at that.
Good luck next weekend.
Yeah, thank you.
First top 10 finish of 1999 for Johnny Benson. By the way, a tip of the hat towards Ricky Rudd, who came home in 14th, his best finish of the year, as Donnie Russell still brings us those pictures from atop the roof at Dover.
9 years ago, Wade Pettengill started as a Jiffy Lube technician, put himself through college, and into management. He'll tell you that Signature Service is more than just an oil change. Wherever you live, you'll find experienced people just like Wade at your neighborhood Jiffy Lube. Jiffy Lube Signature Service Oil Change. Our name is on the line, and we offer Pennzoil.
Today on TNN Motorsports, it's bench racing at its best with some of stock car racing's legends.
Hale, he ran into me on the last lap over the third turn and bumped me up out of the way.
Yeah. I had hit you a time or two that day. But my car was handling so bad.
Two people in here as Hale hit.
Don't miss Stock Car Legends Reunion today after the race at 4:30 Eastern on TNN Motorsports. It's more than country music's biggest night. It's fantastic.
Your votes make it happen.
The TNN Music City News Country Awards.
Everybody's going to be there.
Hosted by Jeff Foxworthy.
And I'm not nominated.
It's a night of nonstop fun
that you won't want to miss.
With performances by Alan, Faith, Vince, Anita, Sawyer Brown, and more.
What a lineup.
And what a night.
The TNN Music City News Country Awards. Live June 14th, 8 Eastern. Only on TNN.
Welcome back, everybody. Don't forget NASCAR Thunder, the official store of NASCAR. New locations all across the country. Want to get the updated list to find out which store is nearest to you? Just call the number you see on the screen, 615-883-7000. And you'll be all set for NASCAR Thunder, the official store of NASCAR, as you look at some of the beautiful countryside just up Highway 13 from where we sit at Dover Downs International Speedway. They call it the Delmarva Peninsula, where Delaware, Maryland, and Virginia all kind of converge. A beautiful part of our country. Well, Dale Jarrett still there. 51 points the advantage.
Picked up a little bit. He came in only 33 ahead. Now he's 51.
It's going to be a big battle with Bobby Labonte. You can't count out Mark Martin.
It's odd to see Jeff Gordon, though, 339 points back at this part of the year,
but he's picked
you can't
up a couple.
You can't cancel him out. Yeah. That race team is too stout to say he's over with.
He was 10th and to be 8th. Now he's up to 6th in points. Well, we appreciate the fans from Nebraska checking us out and their beloved Cornhuskers. By the way, we talked about it when we came on the air at noon Eastern time, all the questions about the higher speeds, how that would affect tire wear and so on. Now, the Goodyear folks did their homework.
They really did. They came up with a terrific tire. It is the same tire they had last year, but it withstood the higher speeds. The drivers did a good job, too. It was a relatively uneventful race. Everybody behaved themselves, did a great job behind the wheel.
When the engineers say it's okay, you can count on it. They said no problem.
Well, some of the folks beating a hasty retreat from Dover Downs International. They have set up some helipads in the NASCAR Busch Series garage area. The war wagons head back to move on to Michigan.
With Matchlight, you get the best charcoal, Kingsford. With just
just the right amount of lighter fluid. Already added. That's why there's only one match for Match Light. Match Light from Kingsman.
Turtle wax. Some people say clear coat cars don't need wax. Clear coat's thinner than the piece of paper. So what protects the clear coat? New Turtle Wax Emerald Series Car Wax.
Waxing with Emerald Series puts on four times the Carnauba wax as the number one brand, with no powdery residue.
Do your best wax job ever. Turtle Wax Emerald Series.
Emerald Series is the best hard shell finish. Turtle Wax.
For a quick touch-up between wax jobs, get new Emerald Series Premium Detailer.
In the racing business, the right hardware at the right time can make the difference between winning and losing.
Try True Value, where you're always a winner, with the right hardware at the right time and at the right price.
Your True Value is the official hardware store of NASCAR, IROC, and Homes Everywhere.
Call it a bonanza, an extravaganza. It's how you save on tires. Now at Pep Boys, all 35,000-mile tires are four for only $99, and all 70,000-mile tires, four for $169.
Pep Boys, cars like us,
people love us.
Ice Sport, the scent of exhilaration from Aquavelva, now available in your skin conditioning gel.
As Bobby Labonte celebrates in victory lane, don't forget, in about 6 or 7 minutes at 4:30 Eastern time, it's that Stock Car Legends reunion we were talking about, when 20 of the NASCAR greats get together to tell stories and reminisce and laugh. And I mean, it was a good time recording that at the NASCAR Cafe in Nashville, Tennessee. It is Stock Car Legends reunion coming up right here on the network. It also brings you that hot air balloon. TNN Motorsports. Ralph Shaheen is caught up with Dale Jarrett.
Eli, at the very beginning of the show, we talked about how Dale Jarrett has been Mr. Consistency all year, and that's why he's in the points lead. Dale, you do that again here today. Another top five, but still just one win. Are you getting frustrated with that, or are you okay with these top fives?
Yeah, no, I'm not frustrated as far as the wins go. I think we'd all like to have it to where we weren't discussing for 30 laps before each pit stop what we needed to change and what major changes we were going to make. It'd be nice to get the car a little bit closer, but that's what's great about Todd. He keeps working and working gets me what I look for and close to what we could. And we made the most of what we had here today. And if we'd have had another caution, we might have made a really major adjustment with some spring rubbers and things. But these are the kind of things that you have to do. We'll just keep plugging along and we gained a few points on the 99, but the 18 is the one I think that's really strong right now. We better be careful of him. But all in all, pretty good day.
Engine looks strong. Is it the chassis then that's a little off right now?
Well, it takes everything to work together. And with the horsepower and torque that we have in the engines at Robert Yates Racing, it makes us work awful hard on the chassis to get that hooked up. So, we've worked in some areas with a different carburetor to try to make it a little bit smoother and then work with the chassis, too, to try to make all of that work. So, our biggest thing is trying to get a happy medium with the car. It seems when we get it to where I can run on new tires, then it's too tight later on. And so we've got to hit a little bit of a happy medium right there. And we got it loose on new tires at one time, but everybody in the world was passing me, so you can't have that. So we're working and working towards it. We just have to find that little bit that we're missing.
Eli, up next is Michigan, a place where Dale had a very famous victory.
Indeed he did. Picked up a big win there. Drag racing with Morgan Shepherd to the stripe when Morgan was driving for the Wood Brothers. That was that first victory there, and it's been a very favorite racetrack for Dale Jarrett over the years. Well, I'll tell you, it's an interesting weekend. Bobby Labonte gets his first win of the season today, and that celebration's going to go on for a while. Dale Earnhardt Jr. yesterday picks up his first win of the season here at Dover Downs. So fans saw some good racing. Next weekend, as Ralph mentioned, you, Buddy, and Dick and the crew going on to work with CBS at Michigan. TNN is going to have the NASCAR Busch Series from South Boston Speedway next Saturday afternoon at 5:30 Eastern. So it's that time of the year where we got something cooking every weekend.
Well, I guarantee you one thing. That South Boston's going to be a barn burner, as Michigan will be also.
So Bobby Labonte gets the win. Johnny Benson breaks through with a top seven finish here today. A solid race, and again, it was a clean race, basically, Dick.
It was, and Tony Stewart with another fourth place finish, his third this year, having a great season.
It wasn't blemish-free, but no race at Dover, Delaware ever is. Glad you were with us throughout the course of the weekend. Down on the pit lane, Glenn Jarrett, Ralph Shaheen, Steve Burns doing yeoman's duty. Up here, of course, Buddy Baker and Dick Bergwin, along with myself, Eli Gold. We're happy you've been with us throughout this weekend for coverage from the Monster Mile. Don't forget, next weekend, Busch Series racing for NASCAR. 5:30 Eastern time next Saturday from South Boston. The Winston Cup teams head to Michigan under the watchful eye of CBS. You'll be able to see that one as well. But for now, we are out of here. Congratulations to Bobby Labonte, our winner of the MBNA Platinum 400. We'll talk to you next weekend with more NASCAR racing here on TNN Motorsports. So long, everybody.
Stock Car Legends Reunion, next on TNN.
This week on NASCAR Garage, we'll get a lesson in chassis adjustments from Gary Nelson, learn to manage fuel consumption, and much more.
NASCAR Garage, this weekend on the leader for motorsports coverage, TNN Motorsports. For you NASCAR fans watching live action from Dover Towns International Speedway, TNN Motorsports presents the Dale Earnhardt 124 scale Wrangler Monte Carlo by Action Performance. Dale Earnhardt ran this extremely rare paint scheme only one time at the Winston on May 22nd, 1999. Now you can commemorate the occasion with this legendary piece of NASCAR history. Paying tribute to his early career success, the number three displayed the famous Wrangler yellow and blue paint scheme. This detailed die-cast car with working hood and trunk is a must for the astute collector and can be yours for just $65 by calling 1-877-TNN-1999. This rare paint scheme is also available in the Action Performance 164 scale size for just $13.95. Call now for either of these limited edition Earnhardt Wrangler collectibles. That's 1-877-TNN-1999. And be sure to ask about other great NASCAR merchandise. Now let's get back to the action live from the Monster Mile at Dover Downs.
This is the Stock Car Legends Reunion with Bobby Allison, Donnie Allison, Buddy Baker,